in the country, both unbeaten, face off for the most sought-after trophy in all of college sport, the Coach's Trophy, presented by Dr. Pepper. And here tonight, we have two of the most storied programs in college football history. Both with more than 800 wins. Way up with bowl victories. Bama leads with national championships since 1936, when the Associated Press first attempted to crown a champion. Heisman Trophy winner Mark Ingram, the very first for Alabama. And so as you look down on this wonderful scene here in Southern California, this was one of the toughest tickets in recent college football memory. The stars of the past from both of these fine schools have arrived here tonight. Right now we go down to two-time Grammy Award-winning artist Audra McDonald for America the Beautiful.
For amber waves of grain, for purple mountains, majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shore.
Beautiful rendition, Kirk. And now as we turn our attention to the game, Texas quarterback Colt McCoy, he can become only the second quarterback in NCAA history to win four consecutive bowl games.
Brent, you and I both know, and everybody watching knows, that for Texas to be able to win this football game, Colt McCoy is going to have to get in the rhythm and have one of those nights. One of the most accurate quarterbacks in the history of college football. Texas needs him to be mobile tonight. Alabama will play a lot of man-to-man coverage, so his feet will be important. And the other thing is great patience from Colt. Alabama's going to try to take away the short, easy throws like Nebraska and Oklahoma did, which will require him to be patient. He may not complete a higher percentage of throws than he's used to, but he's going to get some opportunities downfield for some big plays.
You would think that Alabama could control the clock with their Heisman Trophy winning running back, Mark Ingram.
Well, Mark Ingram comes into this game trying to buck the trend a little bit for Heisman Trophy winners playing in bowl games, especially in the national title. Now, he is a very physical runner. If you've not seen him play a lot, you're going to be surprised to see how quick he is on his feet. The vision is outstanding to find the crease, the power, of course, to break arm tackles. Over 1,000 yards after contact this year. And then the burst, outstanding speed. Now, if you think about it, if you're Texas, you have to take away the running game. That's why we turned our attention to number 12 on the Alabama side, Greg McElroy. He started off fast this year as a first-year starter, first five five games, 9 touchdowns and 1 interception. Then he hit a little bit of a lull. The next 3 games, he started to force the issue. You can see the numbers. He's still winning, but 0 touchdowns and the 2 interceptions. After a bye week, he got back to basics, managing the game better, and you can see 8 touchdowns and 1 interception. Greg McElroy is the key tonight for Alabama's offense because Texas is going to crowd the line. He has to be effective on 1st and 10 passing, much like he was in the game in Atlanta against the Florida Gators.
One thing we should point out, when you go to practice and watch these two fine teams, if you were a scout for the NFL and you were looking for defensive personnel, you'd be drooling at the sight of these athletes, right?
Absolutely. Great speed on both sides, and I think that's one of the reasons they're here. You get so caught up in spread offenses and offensive football, defense wins championships. Both these defenses are in the top 5 in the country, and that's why they're here playing in the BCS national title.
And of course, it was 4 years ago when Texas last raised the championship trophy. This following that classic victory over USC. For Alabama, you got to go back to the pre-BCS days, 1992. Gene Stallings, he'd returned from the Cardinals of the NFL to coach the Crimson Tide. They beat Miami in the Sugar Bowl, and they wrapped up the championship that year. So only the 3rd year for head coach Nick Saban, and I want to tell you, he has maintained tight control over this team all week long. Prior to the start of the ball game, we didn't see many of the Crimson Tide players come out early. It was the Horns who came out a little more relaxed, but it was Saban who was watching the clock, controlling the movement of everybody and everything. Two entirely different coaching philosophies are about to square off here tonight.
Yeah, and one thing's for sure is Nick Saban has his way of getting things done, and so does Mac Brown. And obviously, both are very effective, Brent, as they both got here and have a chance at the national title.
Mad Dog Matson, the strength coach, ready to turn them loose. And here come the Horns. Nick Saban, having given his final thoughts to the Crimson Tide, brings them out of their locker room and toward the field. Saban reminded the team that the 1980 U.S. hockey victory, the Miracle on Ice, was a semifinal. You had to beat Finland to win the gold medal. Tonight, Texas plays the role of Finland as Nick Saban attempts to win his first title ever at Alabama.
Cherry, it has a kiss of cherry flavor. This devilish elixir has a kiss,
Dad,
of cherry.
Dad,
it's not kiss, it's kiss of cherry. It's amazingly smooth. Be smooth.
Dr. Pepper Cherry is amazingly smooth. Trust me, I'm a doctor.
Stage creates the biggest drama. This summer, 31 countries will fall, and one will be crowned champion. Live from
in the second quarter, Alabama's Jesse Bendross caught a 6-yard pass from Walter Lewis. They led it, but then Robert Brewer ran 30 yards into the end zone, a quarterback draw. And finally, Terry Orr scoring his first touchdown of the year on an 8-yard run. Texas won 14-12, and the Longhorns have never lost a game to Alabama. McElroy grew up right here in Los Angeles, Colt McCoy, in a small town, Central Texas, Tuscola, Texas. You look down at this beautiful scene here in Pasadena. Two unbeaten, ready to battle for the heavyweight championship of college football. Jordan Shipley grew up with Colt. Best of friends, still roommates. Now the captains are coming out to the middle of the field. Let's go down now to our championship referee for the Big East Conference, John McDade, with Keith Jackson tossing the coin tonight.
Allow me to introduce Mr. Keith Jackson, who will be performing the coin toss this evening. Mr. Jackson, we have, here's the coin. University of Alabama is in the red. University of Texas is in the white. Here is the coin. On this side, we have the script A, representing the University of Alabama. Should this side land up, Alabama will have won the toss. On this side, we have the Longhorn emblem, representing the University of Texas. Should this side land up, Texas will have won the toss. The coin will be flipped and allowed to be hit the ground. Mr. Jackson, if you would.
Gentlemen, in the lore of football, we call this a hallowed ground. Academia. Enjoy. Here we go.
Take the ball. The coin has a script A facing up. University of Alabama has won the toss. You're going to want to receive the ball.
Yes, sir.
Which goal you want to defend? Which way you want to kick?
We want to defend our end zone.
You want to kick this way, so put your backs over here. Alabama will receive the ball to start the game.
So in a huge surprise, Mack Brown gets to put his defense on the field first, because Nick Saban surprised everyone by taking the ball and not deferring as we get ready. And, you know, ladies and gentlemen, we've always thought through the years that some of the best moments in all of sport come just before the storm, just before the championship begins. So I want you to sit back now, and I want you to enjoy the images of what should be a terrific night here in Pasadena, but with your thoughts accompanying the sights and sounds. Journey begins to the short man, and Alabama will put it in play around the 30-yard line. So a young man who grew up in Los Angeles, a fifth grade, moved to Texas, played high school at a high school powerhouse, South Lake, Texas, about 26 miles northwest of downtown Dallas, is 10 miles from DFW. Played in front of huge crowds, and that's one of the finest high school stadiums you'll ever see. And so here he comes with his family friends from Southern California very much in attendance, and all of his buddies from the Dallas Cowboys organization, where his father works in marketing, one of the vice presidents. The Heisman Trophy winner right alongside him now. Sergio Kendall, he's the target. They have to always account for number two when you come to the line of scrimmage. Ingram stoned. And now our starting lineup for Alabama, presented by Taco Bell. This offensive line, folks, they have not been called for holding in the last 34 quarters. 34. Unbelievable for an offensive line. The skill guys, we've seen Ingram, Julio Jones, you'll meet him. Marquise Mays can get deep. And Peak is a dandy tight end out of Florida, transferred from Georgia Tech. And movement. False start. First mistake of the game, and Carpenter.
77 offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Brent, big thing to remember in this big a game. So much emotion out on this football field for these players dealing with this for the first time in their careers. They played in some big games, but nothing compares to what they're going through emotionally on both sides of the football right now.
McElroy back to pass for the first time. Shakes off. Now he's sacked on the 20-yard line by Lamar Houston, who is the key to that Texas defensive front. His 19th tackle for a loss this year, Herbie.
Well, he's very disruptive. He has tremendous quickness. One of the things that he has to be able to do in this football game is come clear and be able to get back into the face, not only of McElroy in passing downs, but also get into the face of Mark Ingram. He is the key up front. A lot of talk about Sergio Kendall, but it's the senior, Houston, making a big play early for the Horns.
8-yard loss, and it is third and 23, an uncomfortable spot for the Alabama offense. Kendall was coming. They drop it in underneath, incomplete. So the strategy of taking the ball after winning the coin toss backfires on Coach Saban.
This Texas defense has been hearing for the last 32 days that they're not physical enough to match up with the SEC. Here's Jockey Brown and Julio Jones here early saying, let's do this. It's going to be a long game.
P.J. Fitzgerald, a 4-year starter back to punt, and here is Jordan Shipley. He and Arenas are going to have one of the great duels returning punts here tonight if they get a chance. A pass, a fake. Intercepted. Gideon pulls it down as Nick Saban goes way against his coaching philosophy and comes up with a Belichick move on the first drive of the game. Go figure.
Two big surprises by Nick Saban. First, taking the football and then deep in his own territory early in this game, taking a chance, trying to get it to Dre Kirkpatrick, the true freshman. And how about Blake Gideon showing the discipline, getting back, recognizing the football, and being able to secure it to give Texas great field position.
They're across the 40-yard line, and Trey Newton is the running back, number 23. Here is Shipley with his first catch of the game. Now you can expect Texas, Herbie, you and I have talked about this, they're going to come a little up-tempo against this defense to try and keep Saban from over-substituting.
That, and they want to be the aggressor.
Quick snap, quick throw, and they put it in Williams' hands. So first, it was Shipley, then Malcolm Williams as he completes his first two balls, and he suddenly got him in third and short.
They want to get Colt McCoy in this offense in rhythm, and they want to try to challenge Alabama with the tempo. Texas feels that Alabama's had over a month to prepare for this up-tempo offense, but a scout team running it compared to Colt McCoy running it are two different things.
There is Houston, the big defensive tackle. He is directly in front of Cody Johnson. He's the short yardage expert for the Horns. Cody muscles, battles, gets it at the end. It'll be a first down for the Horns.
Remember, this Texas offensive line has been hearing since the Nebraska game that they're the weak link, that they're lucky to be here despite their performance in the game against Oklahoma, Nebraska. They want to come out early in this game and establish a mentality that they're not going to back away from Nick Saban's SEC defense. And in a third and short early in this game, they didn't get big yards, but they were able to create a little bit of pride within themselves by picking up that first down.
Here is Newton trying to get the edge. Shakes a tackler. Comes down the far sideline for another first down. Nate Newton's little boy, Trey. That's a 16-yard run.
Brent, poor angle here by the safety, Justin Woodall. And I really think he underestimated the quickness and speed of Trey Newton on that play.
Now the option look, and Colt McCoy bangs into an offensive lineman who was being pushed back by Dederick. Brandon Dederick was in there, and so too was Darius, number 57. Darius, big time defensive player for the Tide.
Big hit, Marcel Darius, in this football game against this kind of offense. Marcel Darius is the best Alabama defensive lineman creating pressure.
Colt is hurt. That means the untested freshman, that's Garrett Gilbert. He's right out of Austin. McCoy's on the sideline being tended to. They'll use a timeout to give him a little bit more time. Then we'll come back and take a look at exactly what happened here. Didn't look all that serious, but we'll see.
So I asked my dad where he wanted to go for his 60th birthday. Norway, he said, the land of our ancestors. We drank a pint at Ibsen's favorite pub. We sampled the local fare. We got new sweaters.
I feel like yodeling.
It was the trip of a lifetime, Dad said, until we went to the Hall of Records and discovered we were actually Swedish.
Two tickets to Stockholm, please.
Whatever your story is, your Citi card can help you ride it, because Citi never sleeps.
Bet you're one of those multitaskers who wishes you could talk on the phone and surf the web at the same time. AT&T's 3G network lets you do that. Verizon's doesn't. Actually, you can talk on the phone and surf the web with Verizon, but you just need two phones to do it.
Yeah, I got it.
Can I give you a hand?
Thank you. Hello? Yeah. I'm still waiting for it to download.
When you compare, there's no comparison.
Yeah, I'm gonna type it in again.
AT&T, a better 3G experience. Get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate.
Hi, is Denise working?
Yeah, she's in the back. Can I take your order?
I'm just a little bit more comfortable ordering with Denise.
Bye.
Hey, hi, you remember me? I came by yesterday and gave me that five-layer burrito, that new one for
89 cents.
Is that cool? Is that still cool?
It's an inside deal for everyone. Layers of seasoned beef, cheddar cheese, and a hidden layer of nacho cheese sauce. It's Taco Bell's new beefy five-layer burrito for just 89 cents. Why pay more?
Gets credit for being the most fuel-efficient car company in America? Well, then how do you explain all this? Chevy Malibu, Cobalt, Silverado, and the all-new Equinox. Compare them to anyone. May the best car win.
First and second round coverage of the Masters, coming in April on ESPN.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
Looks of concern on that Texas sideline. Colt McCoy suffered a shoulder injury on that hit, and it means that the freshman, Garrett Gilbert, son of Gale, who played eight seasons in the National Football League. He's out of Austin. He has a great upside, but he's very inexperienced. And they bring around the end around for a first and goal at the 1-yard line. That was Monroe, DJ Monroe, who was reinstated.
And a great block here by Kyle Hicks, stealing the corner and allowing Monroe to get there with all of his speed to the edge.
Now quickly right straight ahead. There's a penalty flag. Hang on. Thrown from the side. It is a touchdown if it stands.
Each team on the play have an illegal formation on the offense, five men in the backfield. After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 25 in the defense. That would be penalized half the distance of the goal line, first down.
That is Rolando McClain, the leader of the defense, as the training staff for the Longhorns continues to work on Colt McCoy on the sideline.
You know, Gilbert comes into this game a highly decorated recruit. Very fortunate to be able to pick up the big play with Monroe to get him down inside the 1 yard line. But Gilbert at 6'4", 207 pounds, has been mainly in on mop-up duties. Only has 26 attempts on the year.
Johnson comes back in. Houston and Cobb. Here comes the short yardage expert, and he battles his way to the 1 yard line against that Bama D.
Remember, this Alabama defense, number one in the country as far as red zone defense, only allowing 0.65% of the time their opponents come down in this area. Rolando McClain needs to keep his cool. You mentioned it. He is the leader without question of this Alabama defense.
Second and goal, and Texas comes back up in that power formation. Johnson battling for the end zone, and Bama won't give it to him.
This is why they're number one in the country. They attack you. McClain goes over the top, but you can see Lorenzo Washington, the first one there, the big defensive end, to get in there to make the play. And six or seven crimson jerseys helping out.
And Mount Cody right there in the middle.
Yep.
You can't move him out of the way, or when you're trying to get into the end zone. So here we go again. There's big number 62. 360. We're going to throw with Gilbert, and he'll throw it away. Fourth and goal, and now what does Mac Brown do? Field goal unit trots out onto the field. Your starting quarterback's been knocked out of the game. Saban congratulating the defense for the goal line stand. Maybe taking McCoy back to that locker room for further treatment. So here is Hunter Lawrence, who was the hero of the Big 12 championship. Jordan Shipley is the holder. An 18-yard field goal puts Texas ahead after the turnover, as McCoy will walk back to the locker room. Take a look at the hit. You'll see Darius come in right there on the right shoulder up high, and that appears to be where Colt suffered the injury.
Hey, everybody.
Not too heavy, not too light. Bud Light. The difference is drinkability.
I brought potato salad.
Years from now, how will we look back on today? As the Great Recession, or as the recession that made us great? Allstate has seen 12 recoveries, but this one's different because we're different. We realized our things are not as important as the future we're building with the ones we love. protect yours. Put it in good hands.
Does your phone surf the web? Does your phone surf the web with the speed and power of a pro surfer at Pipeline? Does it bring you the web in all its glory, in all its intended pixels, allowing you to reach the farthest expanses of its universe, deepest depths of its oceans, without getting as much as a grain of sand in your shorts? Droid does. Wave-shredding web speed. In a world of doesn't, Droid does.
Right now, buy a Droid and get a Droid Eris free.
Compare a well-equipped Lexus ES to a well-equipped Buick LaCrosse. Get inside each and see what you find. If perfection is what you pursue, this might just change your course. Meet the new class of world class. The 2010 LaCrosse from Buick. May the best car win.
ESPN's coverage of the Citi BCS National Championship Game on ABC. Brought to you by Citi. Proud to present college football's biggest game. AT&T, a better 3G experience. Bud Light, with the just right taste that's not too heavy, not too light. The difference is drinkability. And DirecTV. No one else has all your favorite channels in HD. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
In less than a week, an entire new field. Sod was brought in from Palm Springs. Field was scraped right after the Rose Bowl victory by Ohio State over Oregon. And a brand new playing surface down here for Texas and Alabama. Tucker. Another short kickoff, keeping it away from the deep men. That's a live ball. Texas goes for it. They may have it. That's live. It is Longhorn football. Another Alabama mistake.
Brett, that's a lot of confusion here. And actually, Julio Jones, of course, should come up and make the catch. But I think he was expecting the up back to come back and make the catch himself, because Julio Jones had so far to come to be able to make that catch. Texas, another opportunity deep in Alabama territory.
Garrett Gilbert, if you just joined us, has replaced the injured Colt McCoy, who appeared to suffer some sort of shoulder injury. We'll get a report a little bit later. He's gone to the locker room. Trey Newton, and now they start to pound a little bit.
This is significant. We didn't have a whole lot of time to talk about it. You go from the all-time career leader in wins with Colt McCoy to a young man that really hasn't taken any meaningful snaps until he's come into this football game right now. You lose the speed and you lose the experience with Gilbert.
So they come with Trey Newton. And Newton is stopped at about the 25-yard line by McClain.
Make no mistake about it now. This young man can throw the football, and they have confidence with his ability to throw, but it'll be a little bit more of a conservative approach by Greg Davis as a play caller for Texas.
Buckner flexes off the line and three wide for Gilbert. Now they empty the backfield. They're going to put it on third and five. They're going to let Gilbert throw it. It is dropped. Pass is dropped by Dan Buckner.
The Texas wide receivers as a group need to understand that with Colt McCoy out, if Gilbert Brown gets it close to you, or if Garrett Gilbert gets it close to you, you have to be able to catch the football and help him out. But I like how they moved him away from the pressure, got him outside of the pocket there on their real first big third down here with the young man in.
There's Hunter Lawrence. Remember now, Shipley's the holder. They have faked a couple. This is a 42-yarder. Hit a 46-yarder against Nebraska to win it. Now the 42-yarder. And Texas builds a six-point advantage following two Crimson Tide mistakes.
Three, two, one.
From the CTS, the most acclaimed vehicle in its class for the last 2 years. Now comes the CTS Sport Wagon. Its technology and performance rivals the Europeans. Its bold design steers clear of the luxury default button. And it could only have come from one place. Stuff goes where you go. New Windows Phone at AT&T.
Pass the calories.
All the day.
Pass the calories.
All the day.
I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. Sting like a bee.
Half the calories, all the cheap.
I don't ask for it.
My bags, we love you.
I'm gonna miss them so much.
Oh, I love those bags.
I love bags.
Bags are my life. Bags are my life. Bags are my life.
It's right here, doesn't it?
That's right.
This is Colt McCoy with his pads off. He is going to the X-ray room here at the Rose Bowl. And they will see if they can study the extent of the damage. The doctor there and the training staff. Mom and Dad, Brad there in the white shirt, was his high school coach. Side obviously concerned about their son as young Garrett Gilbert has now stepped in. Mack Brown's team leads it by a couple of field goals, and if Mack doesn't get Colt McCoy back, they're going to kick it short again, keep it away from Renas and the up back, and they will have it at the 40-yard line. Herbie, take one more look at Darius coming in from behind here on Colt McCoy.
And this is 300 pounds coming downhill in a hurry. And when he came in, I think McCoy thought initially he was going to be okay. And then, of course, he had to take himself out of the football game. And at this point, it's a wait-and-see approach for the Texas medical staff to see what the X-rays show.
Now, back to Alabama. That interception following the fake punt, that ended a string of 309 snaps without a turnover. And then they turn it over a second time with the kickoff team. So it is first down and 10. That won't show as a turnover, but in effect, it was a mental mistake. McElroy can't find a receiver, and he's sacked again. Acho, Sam Acho, there are two, and this is number 81.
Outstanding coverage here by the Texas defensive backs. Watch everybody who's manned up. Even you can see when you go to a nickel package, you have to have the ability to be able to stay with the receivers. And Aaron Williams, one of the top defensive backs in the Big 12, is right there with Marquise Mays. And much like we saw with Colt McCoy against Nebraska, Greg McElroy had nowhere to go with the football. He just had to eat it.
Running Ingram. First down, Bama.
Let's take a look at this. A big run by Mark Ingram. You can see this from the DirecTV ultimate picture cam. He gets to the corner, is able to pick up some good blocks in up front there. Colin Peake's able to help out Julio Jones. It's the first time Ingram has been out in the open space, being able to accelerate into that Texas defense.
Trent Richardson comes into the game, the freshman, but they split him out wide to the right. They spread the field here after the 18-yard Ingram run. McElroy in trouble and sacked again. The offensive line, which had been so good for Alabama against Florida, is having a nightmare here in the early going. That's the third sack of the night. This one by Keenan Robinson.
Will Muschamp's going to bring pressure, but then he's going to show a different look. They're just trying to create some confusion. It's a great job with a zone pressure, a look they've not shown a lot of this year. And on the left side, Carpenter didn't have a chance. I think he assumed that Lamar Houston was coming. He dropped back, and they came with Kendall off the edge.
Fire from the quarterback. Wildcat formation. Richardson goes back into that spot that Ingram has run the Wildcat from. He'll fake it, keep it behind the left side. Battles out close to the 40-yard line. Now this Texas defense. Let's take a look as it is presented by Taco Bell. Herbie's been talking about these fellas. Lamar Houston's off to a big start. Sergio Kendall moves all around. They're the linebackers. Keenan Robinson got free. And, of course, in that secondary and on the kicking team, Blake Gideon with the interception on the fake punt. Earl Thomas is an All-America. Here's third down.
Let's see if Texas brings pressure with another crazy look, or if this time they decide to only rush with four and play zone.
Upchurch is a terrific receiver. Stays in the block. Now he slides out. McElroy can't get him in time. And Alabama is forced to punt. Sam Acho.
We can talk all we want about the offensive line, but this is good time for Greg McElroy on third down. They rush four. They end up dropping some people into coverage, but the Alabama wide receivers right now are losing the battle. Curtis Brown, number three at the top against Julio Jones, matched up in man coverage. He had it in there, but by the time he looked, he was actually starting to bail out of the pocket.
Shipley goes back deep. And remember, Fitzgerald threw the interception. Not faking this time. Booms it high toward the end zone, and it'll go in. It'll be Longhorn football coming out on the 20-yard line. And in case you just joined us, the headline is this. Colt McCoy has been knocked out of the game. Freshman Garrett Gilbert is now the Horns quarterback. They lead it by six.
Scientific tests prove when you drink Dr. Pepper slow, 23 flavors taste even better. For me, slow always produces a hit. Step aside for a minute. Check this out. Slower is better. Trust me. I'm a doctor.
Yeah. Hi, may I help you?
Yes, I hear Progressive has lots of discounts on car insurance. Can I get in on that?
Are you a safe driver?
Yes.
Discount. Do you own a home?
Yes.
Discount. Are you gonna buy online?
Yes.
Discount! Isn't getting discounts great?
Yes!
There's no discount for agreeing with me.
Yeah, I got carried away.
It happens to me all the time.
Helping you save money. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
In the rarefied heights of television, DirecTV soars alone, offering more sports in HD than anyone, a fact not lost on the Renaissance man in front of me.
Football, NASCAR, and the National Hacky Sack Finals all in HD. Now that's a perfect day.
Perfection and Craig Palumbo, synonymous.
To get the most out of your high-def TV, you gotta hook it up to DirecTV.
AT&T's 3G network covers over 230 million Americans. It's a lot of people. To prove my point, I asked Gary here to friend request all of them. How's it coming, Gary?
We got one.
That's good.
Oh.
Hi, wow. Becoming a popular guy.
Want 3G coverage? We've got it. 230 million people in 9,400 cities.
Okay.
AT&T. Get an exclusive Pantech messaging phone free after mail-in rebate, only from AT&T.
Welcome back to Pasadena and the BCS National Championship game. Texas quarterback Colt McCoy is still
back in the locker room area right now. He is being x-rayed. One of the Texas trainers just came out and told me that they are x-raying his right shoulder. Again, he is still back in the x-ray room, and the status about whether or not he will return to this game is uncertain. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Lisa. So here's Garrett Gilbert with Trey Newton getting nowhere on the first down run against that Alabama front, Herbie.
Now you're going to find out what Garrett Gilbert and this offense is made out of. And this is why it's so important as a backup quarterback to be ready. The offense will maintain the same approach with the hurry up, but the plays will be more conservative.
And Newton is thrown for a loss by Eric Anders. That with that tackle, Anders has now had 13 and a half tackles for a loss this season for the Tide.
And when I say conservative, I mean more predictable. This is when Kirby Smart and Nick Saban realize that they've got to do a good job of coming after Gilbert and the running game and the short passes. Make Gilbert go downfield to have any chance of executing.
Sometimes a punt can be a good play. The Horns with their freshman looking at third and 13. Sets a screen and read perfectly by McLean. One of the most instinctive linebackers in the country, and Newton didn't have a chance.
The natural call with a young quarterback is a screen or a draw on third and long. Rolando McLean sees it the entire way. He actually gets out there before Newton is even able to clear the lineman to turn his head back to catch it. Newton never had a chance. It's because McLean read that like a book.
Mac Brown telling us that if Justin Tucker gives Arenas a chance, he's made a mistake. Let's see what Tucker does. He's backed up in the shadow of his own goal line. What they're going to see all night long. Mac saying we're going to punt it out of bounds time after time. Well, something different. The Pro Bowl is coming to Miami, and it'll be broadcast by ESPN. McDonald's presents the 2010 Pro Bowl, and that's the week before the Super Bowl. That'll be some South Beach down there, January 31st. And we've got some alums from these two great programs who are going to be playing in that Pro Bowl. You can see three from Texas and two from Alabama.
These Alabama wide receivers have to do a much better job of getting off of press coverage and working hard at the line of scrimmage to get open downfield to help McElroy out.
Now they go to the pistol formation where the quarterback is not lined up as far for the center as he does in the shotgun. A very familiar formation when you study Bama. And they come with Ingram. He crosses midfield and then is pushed back. They're attacking behind the left side of that line, Herbie, running against the right side of Will Muschamp's defense. We should point out Will Muschamp right there. He learned much of the defenses he calls from Nick Saban. He was an assistant with him at LSU when they won a championship. He went with Coach Saban down to Miami during that brief time that Saban was the coach of the Dolphins. Now he is the coach in waiting for the Texas Longhorns. Second down and two for Bama. Power run, got the first down. First man can't bring him down. Yards after contact continue to add up for the Heisman Trophy winner.
Well, the big question coming into this game was, how would the number one ranked rushing defense in Texas stack up physically to Mark Ingram in this Alabama attack? And up to this point, they've done pretty well. But right now, Ingram may be getting into a little bit of a rhythm, and the offensive line opening up some seams. Texas doing a pretty good job of getting upfield to try to slow down Mark Ingram. If you can make him bounce it to the outside, it really takes away his strength.
Upchurch checks in. Good pass defender. Good receiver. And he'll take it right there on the Wildcat and take off again before he is smacked at the 35-yard line by McElroy, the middle linebacker.
You know, they have run this since you and I called their first game against Virginia Tech, whether it's Ingram or Upchurch. And Upchurch, when he steps into this game, has pretty good acceleration himself. When he came off of the fake to Julio Jones, he started to run downhill in a hurry. And when Alabama's picking up chunks of 5 yards on first and 10, that's Alabama's game.
Richardson's the running back as McElroy returns and is under center. I should say, let me check that, of course, McElroy. backs up, fires to the far side. Julio Jones has a penalty flag also. Julio out of bounds as he crosses the 15-yard line, and there is a penalty flag.
Aaron Williams is in coverage there.
Holding. Number three, defense. This penalty is declined. Result of the play is a first down.
It was Curtis Brown in the corner, and that's a 23-yard gain, Herbie.
Yeah, it's the first time that Julio Jones has been able to turn a defensive back completely around, and then he just set up and found a nice opening in the secondary. But that was, again, man-to-man coverage by Texas, and this time give Julio Jones credit for beating his man.
Ingram back in. Gets the carry, crosses the 10, powers ahead for another first down. It'll be a first and goal.
Well, this is the kind of game that Mark Ingram loves. Look at his vision. Look how he's looking upfield and reading the blocks on the linebackers. Roderick McElroy, the middle linebacker from Texas, has to do a better job of stepping up and filling the gap. That time, he sat back, tried to read it, and he didn't have anywhere to go. And next thing you know, Mark Ingram went right by him.
That is the end of the first quarter. And when we come back, Alabama will see if they can score.
At Pizza Hut, we've got a deal for you. Choose any pizza, any size, any crust, and any toppings, and pay just $10. You want a large meat lover's pizza? $10. Maybe you're more of a large pan supreme kind of person? $10. Thinking of a combination of your own? That's $10 too. That's any pizza, any size, any crust, and any toppings for just $10. All your favorites, now just $10. Only at Pizza Hut.
The same impressive highway fuel economy you get in a Mini, now in a not-so-mini size. The all-new GMC Terrain, with an EPA-estimated 32 miles per gallon highway. May the best car win.
I know, your portfolio's down. Everybody's hurting.
Driver, I need to pick up my dry cleaning. You're a huckleberry.
But switching to Scottrade? What are you going to do, pick your stocks yourself? Yeah, I know they have tons of online research, but you and me, we go way back. Why spoil the fun? The fun.
Come to Scottrade. With the tools, research, and support we provide, you'll wonder why you worked with anyone else.
The fun.
Scottrade. Get invested.
You get a lot of different stuff from her, and it's all right here. Everything sent to you, organized by the person who sent it. The Droid Heiress. The droid that's as connected as you. Exclusively at Verizon Wireless.
Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your hair hang down. Walk right in, sit right down.
Casey Kane here. Enter the ultimate man cave makeover at GreatClips.com.
Great Clips.
We go to great lengths to exceed your expectations. The 5-year, 100,000-mile transferable powertrain warranty from GMC. With roadside assistance and courtesy transportation, it's the best coverage in America.
No hype.
You talk about change. What about sacrifice?
No fear.
Can the general guarantee nuclear information will not be passed to terrorists?
Know why it matters to you.
I'm Diane Sawyer.
World News with Diane Sawyer on ABC.
It's Toyota-thon, an event so big it happens only once a year. Now's the perfect time to get the Toyota you've always wanted, with amazing deals on a huge selection.
I didn't get one.
We've got more.
Toyota-thon's been extended with select rate offers like 1.9% APR financing for 60 months with no payments for 90 days on a new 2010 Toyota Tundra. It's not just an event, it's Toyota-thon. Hurry to your Toyota dealer today.
Make your home more energy efficient. Call Glencoe Foam today.
ESPN, the new home of the BCS.
So So the Crimson Tide threatening here with a second and one. They can actually pick up a first down without scoring a touchdown. And there's Mount Cody, the lead blocker for Mr. Ingram, who has 44 yards already. Now looking over the top for the first down. It'll be first and goal for the Tide.
Anytime the big fella comes in, you're on the defensive side. You better be ready for a big body.
He reminds me so much of William Perry.
Oh, yeah.
The refrigerator for the Chicago Bears. Every time I see him come out onto the field. There is Shonda Ingram, and that is Mark's mom. Many of you have read the story of his father, Mark Sr. He's in prison, convicted on bank fraud and money laundering charges. They stay very, very close. It was a tremendous Heisman Trophy ceremony. Mark was very emotional. Talked about his father as he dashes into the touchdown and gets one for dad. Sophomore from Flint, Michigan, and I'm going to tell you an interesting story about Shonda. Nick Saban was an assistant coach at Michigan State at the time, and the head coach said, Nick, keep an eye on Mark Ingram Sr. I want to see that he goes to class. We've got to keep this rascal eligible. He's a key to our team. Well, Nick didn't know what to do, so he went to his girlfriend, who was then not married to Mark, Shonda, and between the two of them, they kept an eye on Mark Sr. And then when young Ingram graduated from high school in Flint, Michigan, and it was time to go to college, Shonda remembered Coach Saban, and that's why the young man has traveled down from Michigan to Alabama, and the Crimson Tide faithful are so happy he made that trip south. Two carloads of fans drive down from Flint, Michigan, Herbie, to every Alabama game. Haven't missed one. And here he is, get the Heisman. You were there that
night. Yeah, I was. It was very, very special to see. He wins the trophy. There's Colt McCoy right there, of course, first guy to congratulate him. And got pretty emotional up there, and I really thought it was one of the better speeches. He gathered himself for a 19-year-old to win the first Heisman Trophy for that great institution, to be able to gather himself, step back away from the mic. I thought he was a real class act in the way he handled himself and represented his school, himself, and his family.
Only a sophomore. He'll be back. And SEC defenses are not happy about that. 47 yards tonight, rushing, and one touchdown, and the first man just can't bring him down. So Bama leads for the first time tonight. Kickoff fielded by Goodwin. Track speed, looks for a seam, and he'll be down on the 25-yard line.
Break. It was a great touchdown by Ingram. Let's watch the block up front by big Mount Cody. Texas was so scared on the previous play. They just said, if 62's coming through with 350 pounds, I think I'll just step out of the way this time.
You know, everybody loves a big man. I mean, Les Bingaman was probably the first big one that I can remember with the Detroit Lions and nose guard in the National Football League and back in the day. And here we got Mount Cody. Now first down and 10 for Gilbert and the Horns. Here's Newton into the middle and stoned. Josh Chapman and Darius. Marcel Darius is a fine football player, number 57.
One of the better defensive linemen in the SEC. And right away, we're starting to see in the last two or three series with Colt McCoy out, the inexperience of Gilbert, you're seeing a much more conservative approach, and Alabama is attacking this Texas offense.
They'll run the toss play. There's a penalty flag thrown by the umpire at the offensive line on this play. And this is a Big East officiating crew. McDade's our referee.
Personal foul. Chop block. Number 52 offense. Now he's off the distance to the goal line.
You know, they had two chop blocks called against them in the Nebraska game. And Mack Brown thought they were both bad calls. And now here's the first one here tonight against Charlie Tanner. Take a look.
Well, I think this is a good call. To the right there. Once you're engaged with an offensive lineman, another offensive lineman cannot submarine a defensive lineman. So the one thing that Texas can't afford to do with a young quarterback in is self-destruct deep in your own territory, and now face a second and 23 and eventually a third and long, because Alabama knows what's coming. The screens, the draws, very predictable here, again with a play calling with a young guy.
Greg Davis upstairs trying to keep it simplified, and end around now. They put it in the hands of the former quarterback, John Childs, who now is a wideout. So Greg is still trying to dial up some high percentage plays. As you remember, he threw that screen pass that McClain ate up. And at some point, you're going to have to be downfield.
Yeah, and I think on early downs, you're better off taking that chance. Greg Davis on the left there with the glasses. It's almost like Greg Davis has one arm tied behind his back right now, trying to call the plays with a young quarterback.
Third down and 15. Hit on a release. It's ruled incomplete. And that was Courtney Upshaw. One thing about this Bama defense, they are so deep.
And they give you so many different looks. The one thing that they have is speed and execution. And this time he goes right around Kyle Hicks, the junior, and is able to get in there and put the pressure on Garrett Gilbert. The game is moving very fast for Garrett Gilbert, like any other freshman quarterback, when he goes out there against this Bama defense in this big a game.
Arenas standing back on the 40. And Tucker. And Arenas is going to get a shot, and he's hit right away at the 43-yard line. Terrific coverage, but it didn't get out of bounds.
Brent, I think Garrett Gilbert may have taken a shot there on that third down. He may be injured as well.
That will be the second quarterback knocked out.
Savings with a Citibank CD. Go to citibank.com/CD.
I lost 54 pounds by reducing my daily calories and replacing my usual fast food with Taco Bell's drive-thru diet. That's 7 delicious items, all under 9 grams of fat. When I decided to trim down, I knew I had to be realistic with myself. I didn't want to cut out my fast food, so I started choosing Fresco items from the drive-thru diet menu. These results aren't typical, but for me, they're fantastic.
The Taco Bell drive-thru diet. Hear Christine's amazing story and download a coupon for a free Fresco taco at drivethroughdiet.com.
Hey, you match black in the game.
Oh, sorry, I'm just checking the other scores.
Is my map in the way? No, you good.
To get almost 5 times more 3G coverage than AT&T, come to Verizon Wireless, where you'll find smartphones under $100, like the BlackBerry Tour, Droid Eris with Google by HTC, or the new BlackBerry Curve for just $79.99. Verizon Wireless.
Hi, I'm Stormy Simon. Overstock.com is an online department store where everything's always on sale. You can save up to 70% on clothing, pearls, diamond jewelry, furniture, down comforters, digital cameras. We have thousands of items on sale. No matter how many items you buy, the whole order will ship to you for just $2.95, even if it's 100 things. We also have a customer service team available for you 24 hours a day. Overstock.com, at home with the O.
Guarantee your savings with a Citibank CD. Go to citibank.com/CD.
ABC Monday.
Wow.
Here comes the bride, Alyssa Milano.
It's my wedding day, and you show up.
You two know each other?
She's the one that got away.
ABC's Castle. All new Monday at 10, 9 central on ABC.
So Colt McCoy does not look happy as he leaves the x-ray room and goes back toward the Longhorn locker room underneath. And now with young Gilbert shaken up, well, you know, Vince Young, as Kirk Herbstreit said during that commercial, he left with a year of eligibility.
Get him out there.
Now McElroy on a play action to Richardson, and Richardson breaks a tackle and battles for a first down. So on their first series after the interception, Darius from behind suffered a right shoulder injury. Now hit by Courtney Upshaw, and Gilbert is receiving attention over on the sideline, but he appears to be okay. He is up, conferring with Greg Davis, and the assistants up on top. Bama leads Texas by a point, 7-6. Trent Richardson, the freshman from Pensacola, Florida, and dropping back was Preston Dial. Make sure he was all set. Here's Richardson. Let's go down below now to Tom Rinaldi. Tom.
Well, Brent, Gilbert took a pop on that right shoulder, according to trainers. He was just put through some range of motion exercises. He's worked it out, ready to head in for the next series. Brent.
All right, thank you, Tom.
Brent, I don't know if you're noticing this, but since the injury to Colt McCoy, I think it's affected not only Gilbert in the offense, but also the defense. They've lost a little bit of their stinger, their confidence. They seem to be playing a little bit cautious right now. And meanwhile, Alabama's playing with a great deal of confidence and very aggressively now on both sides.
Roy Upchurch checks in as the running back as they continue to alternate backs. Play action, McElroy. Looking to go deep and can't get it off. Sacked at the 45 by Sergio Kendall. That is the fourth sack by Texas of McElroy here tonight.
And Sergio Kendall's just kind of sitting on Colin Peake, waiting for the play. And then once he realizes that McElroy, again, doesn't have anybody to throw the football to downfield, he's waiting and waiting for Hanks or somebody to break free. That's when Kendall decided to turn it loose and come up with a big play. Need your leaders to step up when the game's on a line like this, early like this, because of the injuries, and that time Kendall did.
Alabama in an uncomfortable third down. Upchurch barges across midfield. And now they will leave it up to P.J. Fitzgerald to drop a punt inside the 20-yard line if he can. A four-year starter out of Coral Springs, Florida. And that is Brad McCoy, Colt's father, heading inside the Texas Longhorn locker room to see his son. Jordan Shipley, he'll signal for the fair catch right near the 15-yard line. A one-point national championship game, second quarter, Pasadena.
The war tore a hole in the sky. Only a few survived. Our only hope is in my hands.
Critics are calling The Book of Eli an awe-inspiring epic.
Give it up or I swear I'll bury you.
Nobody touches it but me.
Stunning, thrilling, revolutionary.
It's not a book, it's a weapon!
An absolute must-see. Denzel Washington is phenomenal. He has never been better.
I will fear no evil.
The Book of Eli. Rated R. Starts January 15th.
AT&T's 3G network lets you talk and surf the web at the same time. Verizon's doesn't. Excuse me.
Yeah, hey, Rick. What, you're on a game show right now?
What's the capital of Peru?
Come on, man, hurry. You gotta help me.
That'd be Lima.
My answer is Lima. You just won $1 million.
Okay, now, I better get a cut of that.
When you compare, there's no comparison. AT&T, a better 3G experience. Get an exclusive Pantech messaging phone free after mail-in rebate, only from AT&T.
Cargo Incognito. Introducing the Accord Cross Tour from Honda.
Here's one for you. If me and Buster were hanging over a cliff, and you could only save one of us, which one would you save?
Easy, you.
Ooh, me or your mom?
Sorry, Mom.
Your Miller Lite.
Oh, man. How high's the cliff?
Do you love the taste of your beer this much? Well, you could. Try the great Pilsner taste of a triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness.
If me and Buster are hanging off a cliff, what is she talking about? I know.
ESPN's coverage of the Citi BCS National Championship Game on ABC. Brought to you by Citi, proud to present college football's biggest game. The all-new Accord Cross Tour from Honda, versatility modernized. Allstate, proud sponsors of college football. Are you in good hands? And Miller Lite, triple hops brewed for that great Pilsner taste. Taste greatness.
With Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brett Musburger. We welcome you back on a beautiful night, one of the few parts of the country which is enjoying good weather over the last few days. And there you see that the defense get ready. They have dominated this Longhorn offense. Young Gilbert up to the line, Herbie.
Brett, I think he's got to take some chances downfield.
He does just that, incomplete. Tried to get it to Shipley, threw down the middle.
He's been in this game for three series, and he's not been able to produce a first down since he's been in. The game has really shrunk. Right now, Alabama feels like they're defending this young quarterback from about 5 yards and in, with most of it being running plays. That's why I think Greg Davis said, hey, guys, we've got to take a chance and be willing to try to get the ball thrown downfield.
Arena shows blitz. He's coming. And Gilbert is tackled at the 15-yard line. Javier Arenas coming off the corner, number 28.
And this is exactly what they're going to do. With a young quarterback and an offensive line coming off of a game where they gave up 9 sacks to Nebraska, they're a big gunshot. All you have to have there is you got to be able to change the offensive line's protection to the right. The tight end that time needed to be able to pick up that blitz, Greg Smith. But without Colt McCoy in there to direct the traffic up front, there's an Achilles heel now up front.
And Cody was stone in the middle. Deflected, incomplete. And the Horns are forced to punt again.
And Nick Saban is very content playing field position right now with this Texas offense. He's incredibly confident along with Kirby Smart because they know that this offense is limited. They've got great field position. It's a matter of time if the game continues like this until they can capitalize and come up with some points.
Another great play by McClain. What a fabulous linebacker. The Butkus Award winner. Certain first-round draft choice coming up. Now they put Julio Jones back with Arenas to try and spread the field against the strategy, the rugby punting effort of Tucker to go out of bounds. And here's Arenas from the 44-yard line. Shakes a tackle. Looking for the NCAA record. Thrown down at the 49-yard line. That was Sam Acho making the stop. You're watching the Citi BCS National Championship on ABC.
Introducing the Accord Cross Tour from Honda.
Okay, class, our special guest is here, Ellen Page.
Hi! We're going on a field trip to China!
Wow! When I was a kid, we would just go to the farm. No, seriously, where are you guys going?
The new classroom. See it, live it, share it on the Human Network. Cisco.
Hey, Vincent!
Go State!
Hey, Ham. Why did that guy call you Vincent?
Because that's my real name, Bergwood.
It is? How do you know that?
He's my Allstate agent.
Oh, he insures your car.
And my boat.
You got a boat?
Ah, my wife is a big-time skier.
You're married?
Allstate agents know who you really are. They can help you save money by combining your car insurance with home, boat, and more. Are you in good hands?
Where'd you meet your wife?
Pilates.
She's European.
Pass the calories.
All the G.
Pass the calories.
All the G. All the G.
I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. Float like a butterfly. sting like a bee. I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. Sting like a bee.
Half the calorie, all the tea.
I don't ask for it.
Well, here's our view from our DirecTV Ultimate Picture Cam on this beautiful night here in Pasadena, California. Two unbeatens. Alabama, number one. Texas, number two. Bama leads it by a point, and Texas has lost its star quarterback, Colt McCoy, to a shoulder injury. Now, there's the pistol, and that's Richardson, the freshman right behind McElroy. Richardson to the left side, and he is brought down. McElroy, number 38, senior.
Really nice job there by McElroy. He is so important to the Longhorns' effort to slow down not only Richardson, but obviously Mark Ingram. And it's all about seeing it, trusting it, and then attacking downhill. Coaches say that his greatest strength with the experience are his instincts. You could see it right there.
Handoff, Richardson bolts up the middle for the end zone. This could be a touchdown. Put it on the board for Bama. A 49-yard burst by the talented freshman from Pensacola. Tiffin, whose daddy was a legend down Bama way. Van Tiffin, who can forget that 52-yarder against Auburn? Lee tacks on another extra point.
He's got just as much speed, maybe even a little bit more than the Heisman winner Ingram.
Hi, is Denise working?
Yeah, she's in the back. Can I take your order?
I'm just a little bit more comfortable ordering with Denise.
Bye.
Hey, hi. You remember me? I came by yesterday and gave me that five-layer burrito. That new one for
89 cents.
Is that cool? Is that still cool?
It's an inside deal for everyone. Layers of seasoned beef, cheddar cheese, and a hidden layer of nacho cheese sauce. It's Taco Bell's new beefy five-layer burrito for just 89 cents. Why pay more?
I'm all shook up. Well, I'm missing all the times we had together.
Windows stuff goes where you go. New Windows Phone at Verizon.
Golden Globe nominated Modern Family is the hottest thing on TV.
Look at that, two things flaming at once.
And ABC Comedy Wednesday, the show that's on every top 10 list, is all new. It's television for everyone.
Did you do that thing where you get frustrated and you start pressing all the buttons?
No.
If you know how to use it.
Our home theater system is a human body. The TV is the face.
I know what part you are.
ABC's Modern Family, all new Wednesday, 9, 8 central on ABC Comedy Wednesday.
The biggest stage creates the biggest drama this summer. Live from South Africa, the 2010 FIFA World Cup on ESPN, coming in June.
7 minutes and 59 seconds left. The two youngsters who rushed for touchdowns. Heisman Trophy winner and his young buddy Richardson. Ian Ingram have led the way. 92 rush yards for Alabama in this game. Now the short kickoff from Bama. Get it to the 40-yard line.
Brett, one of the risks you take with movement with this defensive line is opening up creases. Watch the block by the left guard here, Mike Johnson. James Carpenter, 77, comes off of his block and picks up Keenan Robinson. And with a poor angle by Blake Gideon, there's nobody left right there. So even when Ingram steps down, the true freshman, Trent Richardson, has been doing it all year for the Crimson Tide.
Fozzie Whitaker has checked in. Sprinting around end is Monroe to the outside. Monroe across the 35-yard line. And that's the second time tonight that they have brought DJ Monroe off the edge, this time for 28 yards.
And watch Fozzie Whitaker lead the way, Brent, 28 with a great block right there. Just enough of catching Mark Barron to be able to spring him loose. And when Monroe turns it on, it's tough to catch him.
This could be a spark for the Horns here, who need something to happen. And they run with Whitaker. So Fozzie Whitaker handling the ball for the first time. Keep in mind that this young man, number 28, can also throw an option pass. And now they put Gilbert up under center. They fake. Gonna go toward the end zone. Incomplete. Malcolm Williams, the intended target, and off the play action, they had him.
Great sequence of plays here by Texas. They had Alabama on their heels. They had the opportunity. The ball is thrown where it needs to be. It would have been a tough catch, but Malcolm Williams at 6'3 has to go up there and help the true freshman out and make the catch. Greg Davis thought he had it.
Trey Newton comes in from the Longhorn sideline. He's the running back on 3rd and 5. Gilbert under pressure and intercepted. Picked off by Arenas. Arenas kills the drive with the Alabama interception.
Once you throw into the middle of this Alabama defense on 3rd down, they got away with a hold, Darryl McClain. You know that you're taking a major risk. Arenas, one of the better cover men in college football, is there perfectly. And actually, I think Jackson may have had a chance there too. So with a young quarterback, you've got to get him out on the edge and away from the middle of that defense.
Gilbert has no chance against Saban's defense.
No.
You're absolutely right.
Yeah. You're a young guy. Just get him on the edge, make it simple reads. He can't be reading the middle of this Alabama defense, especially on 3rd down.
Ingram back in. The hand coming left side. Look at the power that he demonstrates. You have to be so impressed as you watch Mark Ingram how infrequently the first tackler can bring him down, Herbie. I mean, if you make contact on him and forget about it.
Yeah, you better get low and you better wrap up. But I, for you and I to see here and call Alabama's last game, going back to early September when they played Virginia Tech, the big question was McElroy and the left side of the offensive line with James Carpenter coming in, replacing the Outland winner, Andre Smith, Mike Johnson, the glue in the center, Vlahos. What a great season, and that was a great play there by the left side.
Ingram again. 9 more yards. Take a look at yards after contact by number 22. It's unbelievable.
He came into the night with over 1,000 yards, as you talked about, Brent. And there's just on one play, 2 different times, Texas defenders are trying to use just arm tackles. Here's McElroy, one of the more physical tacklers on this defense, and he runs right through him and Earl Thomas. And if Julio Jones' left leg didn't get there, then Ingram goes into the end zone.
2nd down and 1. He comes again behind the left side, breaks another tackle, and makes his way to the 45 And this is a will-breaking drive. One of several that Bama's had this year.
Will Muschamp's going to have to make some adjustments. Right now, Alabama is getting to the edge, and it's rather easy for them. You're seeing the big left tackle, 77, Carpenter seal it. And Julio Jones, who's lined up into the boundary, one of the more physical blockers in the SEC for a big wide receiver. He's taking his man out. There's nobody left on the edge.
Trent Richardson's back on the field. An abundance of riches for Jim McElwain, who is upstairs calling the Bama plays. Here's Richardson again. And he too breaks a tackle and makes it to the 40-yard line. So McElwain, who had his Bama offense under the gun against Auburn, and he dialed up a sensational drive, and he's calling the plays now for the Crimson Tide here tonight.
We're beginning to get our answer about Texas being the number one ranked rushing defense in college football. A lot of people felt, is that because of a result of playing in a Big 12 where it's more finesse and a little bit more of the spread? Or is that a result of them actually being physical and being dominant early? We're seeing it's favoring Alabama.
Second down and five. McElroy going to go deep down that far sideline. Double coverage out of bounds. Gideon had come over the top to help Williams against Mays that time. So Mark Reese Mays, the intended target.
Well, the Texas defense is holding up very well on the perimeter in pass coverage. I mean, Aaron Williams is doing a good job. Curtis Brown, Shockey Brown, Gideon, Earl Thomas. They're making it tough on McElroy, but where they've got to get better is as a group, gang tackling and becoming more physical against this running game.
On third down, the Texas defense has stopped Bama. They're 0 for 3, and here they are again now. This a little more manageable number. Need only five. The handoff to Richardson. He did not get it. Terrific play by Earl Thomas, the sophomore from Orange, Texas, and one of the real good ones.
Great job of filling the hole here. You see him at the top coming downhill in a hurry, and what helped him that time is Aaron Williams, the corner, that time was able to contain the back and force him to cut back underneath, and there's Earl Thomas waiting for him to come up with a big stop.
So Fitzgerald out to punt, and Shipley standing about the 10-yard line. Bluffs the fair catch, but Bama's going to cover it inside the five. Tough spot for Garrett Gilbert. And we want to remind you that on ABC, next Thursday, two of television's biggest shows reunite and the sparks will fly. An all-new Grey's Anatomy. And then Private Practice crossover event next Thursday starting at 9, 8 Central on ABC. 3:50 to go here in the first half. The major headline is that quarterback Colt McCoy was knocked out, injured shoulder, first series of the game, has not come back. They're still evaluating. His father's inside the locker room. Now, Garrett Gilbert, the freshman, backed up against his own end zone, keeps it and sneaks out to the four. We go down below to Lisa Salters.
Well, Brent, Colt McCoy will not be back for the rest of this half. We're being told by the training staff that they're going to reevaluate him more at halftime. Right now he's back there getting treatment, and they're continuing to examine him. Guys.
3:29 left in the half. Second down and eight. Long handoff, Newton, behind the left side. And now, Herbie, the horns will be in third down.
Yeah, and it goes back to the game plan of Nick Saban. If he's not going to be able to score, very content with moving this young quarterback inside his 10-yard line. Because of the play calling, Nick is very confident with what is coming after him. It's very conservative. They know they have to. Texas has to be very, very sensitive and careful not to turn the football over deep inside their own territory.
14-6 is one thing. 21-6 is something else entirely. Third down and six. They put Gilbert back in the gun. Pump fake. Got a wide open receiver. Incomplete. He had Shipley.
Alabama does not think that Texas is willing to throw it downfield, and that's why they have to be willing to take some chances. You have to applaud the effort there. He missed it. They weren't able to execute. But look at Shipley. That's your man. One-on-one. Throw it to the outside, and you've got about a 35-yard gain.
Great double move that Shipley put on the corner coming out of there. Johnson was the corner for Bama, and now Tucker's back in the end zone. There's 2:30. There's time now here for Alabama. Jones and Arenas are going to have good field position. On the fly from Arenas, McElroy and the Tide will start from the 29-yard line. 2:20 left here in the first half.
It's exactly what Alabama wants to see. It's a matter of time. You keep pushing the quarterback back. You get good returns with Arenas. You keep pushing Texas back further and further and further. Now Alabama has to capitalize on this opportunity with such great field position.
Ingram will be the running back. Hanks, Mays, and Jones are the wideouts. Peaks, your tight end. Here's Ingram. And again, attacking the left side and breaking that first tackle. Well, a reminder that you can own a piece of history by downloading the full-length BCS National Championship game on iTunes. So go to iTunes.com/ESPN. iTunes.com/ESPN. Click on the BCS logo, and you can download it. Second down and four here, Herbie.
Mark Ingram continues to work the outside of the Texas defense, and once in a while they go back in and get the matchup they want with the blocking angle back to the middle of the defense.
Ingram cuts back. Battles for the first down.
There's another example of this play being designed to get to the outside, and watch how quickly Mark Ingram at 215 pounds can stop on a dime and cut back. That's what makes him so effective in this offense. What the offensive line wants to do is push you to the sideline, and to do that, you need a back with vision to find the crease and get upfield.
First and 10. Stretches. Battles for a couple of yards. Does it remind you at all of Emmitt Smith?
I know a lot of people have said that. I mean, there are a lot of similarities. He doesn't have blazing speed, but he has enough speed to be able to be dangerous when he gets into the open field, and his balance is...
Well, that's the one thing that, yeah, that you would wonder about, because nobody, no running back ever had better balance than Emmitt Smith when you think of him. And, of course, Jerry Jones and the front office have come up here tonight to watch this game, and you would think that they are all Texas Longhorn fans. But it is because of young McElroy. His daddy works in the front office for the Cowboys. And Jerry Jones said, listen, I love everything about Texas, but McElroy is family.
He is family, and right now he's on top of things. This is a drive that is very, very important for both teams. The way the game has gone, Texas had some breaks. They were able to come up with 6 points. Obviously, the injury to Colt McCoy. Bama's come on strong with 14 unanswered. Now it comes down to Alabama trying to execute in the red zone. Kind of a problem spot for them this year. And Texas has to hold them to a field goal attempt to feel that they can still come back in the second half and win this.
Trent Richardson back in as the Bama running back. A little bit of a draw play, and McElroy jumps in from that linebacking spot and makes the stop.
Here's another difference in the game with Colt McCoy out. With a, you know, you get a minute 15, you make the tackle on third down. If you have confidence in your defense that they can come up with a stop, you're going to call a timeout right now for Texas, because you want to give Colt McCoy time to throw. Right now, they're just trying to limp into the locker room, and they're not worried about getting the ball back and scoring.
Third and 7, bootleg McElroy. He can run. Slide, dives a little bit short. It is short of the first down, and now it is Saban who will have a decision to make.
The Texas defense had to make a decision. They had two defenders out there, a little bit of confusion, and finally Keenan Robinson, the linebacker, comes back just in time to keep McElroy short of that first down marker.
They waste some precious seconds and finally call a timeout. I'm very surprised that Saban didn't immediately call the timeout and decide to go for the first down with Ingram, a power back, or let the clock run down and then kick the field goal. You got a 14-6 here with 33 seconds, but clearly they had not decided on that sideline what they wanted to do.
Yeah, I don't think they were sure, and if anything, it makes you think maybe that there's a better chance that they're going to go for the field goal here, and he's just letting some time run.
And if you are Texas against this field goal, you're thinking, watch out the fake. You're behind 14-6. You got 33 seconds you're looking at. They can get the first down and get that clock stop. Here is Lee Tiffin, 82 career field goals. Now the punter, P.J. Fitzgerald, he's already thrown one pass tonight as a punter. This is a 26-yard field goal. Saban says we'll take the points. Can't argue with that. 17-6, 23 on the board here in the first half. Well, a reminder now that you can log on to all of those special sites, Boston, Dallas, Los Angeles, Chicago, ESPNLosAngeles.com. You got the latest in Kobe Bryant and what's going on with the Los Angeles Lakers. And here tonight, of course, tomorrow down in Dallas, everybody will be dialing in to see what's going on as we look at this beautiful scene. And Herbie, it is 10 o'clock back in the East, and for some of those people who have arrived home, especially out here in the Pacific just a short time ago, major headline is that Colt McCoy was knocked out of this game on the first drive. Texas kicks a couple of field goals, but Bama has 17 unanswered.
Yeah, and right now Texas is obviously on a slide at 17-6, giving 17 straight points up. It's going to be interesting. Mack Brown gets in there at halftime to talk with Greg Davis, his offensive coordinator. First and foremost, what's the status? Do I have my quarterback back, or am I going to have to continue to play with a true freshman? Tough deal. They're going to have to take some chances if they want to come back and have a chance of winning this game in the second half, throwing the football downfield and believe in the young man.
Tiffin with the ball on the tee. From the 5-yard line, here comes Goodwin to the 27-yard line. So this was the first series after the Bama turnover, and McCoy is hit. Darius injured shoulder. He has gone out. A couple of things to keep in mind. This young man has an NFL future. His father has gone inside the locker room. I'm sure that he is talking with the medical people. They'll do what is best for Colt McCoy in this situation. Now, young Garrett Gilbert, who is the future quarterback for the Longhorns and who has struggled here, brings him out. There is Trey Newton on the first down handoff. Strong run for 9 yards.
Texas looks like they're going to call a timeout there on the sideline. Interesting. You know, you think they're going to try to run the football and maybe just be content just to try to get out of here without turning the ball over potentially again to this Alabama defense. But they run the football, pick up 9 yards, and now maybe with such a great kicker in Hunter Lawrence, maybe they're thinking, you know, let's take a shot downfield and see if we can come up with a catch and pass interference and maybe get into field goal range.
When you think about the Texas receivers, both Williams and Buckner had shots here in the first half that they probably should have held on to.
Yes.
One of which by Williams would have been a touchdown.
It would have been a huge play. And somebody within the offense, a leader, a Jordan Shipley, somebody needs to talk about helping this quarterback out in the second half if he's going to be out there and giving him confidence that they believe in him.
Here's Gilbert, that inside shuttle pass.
Incomplete,
or is it a fumble? Picked up by Darius. Darius in the air. Darius going for the end zone. That could be a touchdown. If he's got it in the air, that's an interception and a touchdown. That was a shuttle pass, remember. And the way they're celebrating, you think in all the world that Marcel Darius, who knocked Colt McCoy out of the game, now the officials are going to huddle. Obviously, instant replay. We'll take a look at the replays upstairs and make sure. But if he caught it in the air without it hitting the ground, interception, touchdown, yep. Alabama.
His only play is an interception. a touchdown. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 57 on the scoring team. The 15-yard penalty will be enforced with a kickoff.
Well, that play happened so fast, the shovel pass. I really thought that with the juggling that the ball may have hit the ground, but it did not. And that's exactly what Texas did not want to do. They wanted to get to the halftime, 17-6. They're the ones who called the timeout.
The Tiffin on the field, a buzz in the crowd. The dagger may have come out early. Tiffin tacks on another.
And even the play call with a shovel pass, you're going to think that the worst case, Monroe's going to drop it and it's incomplete. The ball is bouncing all around. Right there, I thought it may have hit the ground, but no chance. He is all over that. And big number 57 tonight, Darius, has been a big factor. He's the young man who knocked Colt McCoy out. He's had a lot of opportunities to get pressure on Gilbert. And this time, very alert. Keep in mind, he's 300 pounds. What an athlete. Exactly what Nick Saban needed. That's what he's been waiting for, an opportunity to get the freshman to turn the football over, and he finally got it.
24-6. Marcel Darius out of Huffman, Alabama. Just a sophomore, just a baby. Trying to pick up his spirits over there on the Texas sideline, trying to get him to hang in. No one knows for sure whether or not Colt McCoy will be able to come back in the second half. We'll have to wait and see. X-ray of that injured shoulder, father in the locker room. On the ground. Running the clock out. Coming to the end of the first half. Alabama takes charge after the Colt McCoy injury. The Heisman Trophy winner with 90 yards, and let's go down to Lisa.
Thanks, Brent. Mac, why take that chance with your backup quarterback at the end of the half with that shovel pass?
Well, the chance is about as safe as you got, Lisa. It's an underneath shovel pass. It's like a draw. If it's not open, you throw it in the ground. We were trying to get past the 50 so we could take a deep shot.
What's your training staff telling you about the status of Colt McCoy?
It's just a shoulder, and they're reevaluating. We got to plan on playing without him. We got to do a better job than we're doing. We gave up the big run. We gave up the useless one there at the end, and Alabama's playing hard. So we got to regroup and do a better job second half.
Thank you very much, Mac. Now let's send it over to Tom Rinaldi. Tom.
Thanks very much. It's a great ending to the half, Nick. But with Colt McCoy being knocked out, how did that affect your defense strategy and particularly your ability to be aggressive?
Well, you know, we had a different plan completely, but they would be a lot better team because he's a great player. So it's unfortunate for them. And we haven't stopped the run as well as we need on some of those speed sweeps and so forth. So we're going to have to make some adjustments to that. I'm sure they're going to open it up more, and we're going to have to play for 60 minutes in a game.
Thanks very much, Nick. Appreciate it. Brent.
All right, Tom and Lisa, thank you. And a reminder now to stay tuned for the halftime show from the Citi BCS National Championship. Colt McCoy knocked out. And we'll be back after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Cross Tour with available four-wheel drive from Honda.
So here we are in the fourth quarter. No time left, and the touchdown is under review.
Hey, guys, what do you think?
We're not ready to go yet. Is there any way you can send this thing into overtime? Yeah.
No problem.
I don't know what he was looking at, but we're going into overtime.
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
This could finally end it. Unbelievable.
ABC Thursday, January 21st.
I'm 6'2".
I don't think you're than 6'3".
I know that first-year associates are competitive, but I suppose I should be happy your belts are still buckled.
ABC's The Deep End, series premiere Thursday, January 21st on ABC.
Let's get together.
Ready for an awesome lineup of All-American flavors? Then get your team to Beef O'Brady's. Rush our mouth-watering wings, blitz our juicy burgers, hefty sandwiches, and fall off the bone ribs. Touchdown, Beef's. Good times, great values. Get them together at Beef's.
If you got the spirit, bring it on at Beef's and get together. See ya, Beef's.
Aptree Honda wishes you a happy new year. We're having a new year sale with savings on vehicles that hold their value, get really good fuel economy, and have a low cost to own. This will help your year be happy all year. See the all-new Cross Tour and the other 2010s. Doing business with us is easy and friendly. That's why every month over 50% of our business is from previous customers and referrals. Save during our new year sale at Aptree Honda, where we sell for less the professional way. I-26 and Airport Road, Asheville.
Make your home more energy efficient. Call Glencoe Foam today.
At halftime, the Tide rolling up 24-6, playing with extra gusto. Now the Alabama Million Dollar Band under the direction of Dr. Ken Ozello.
A Cole Porter classic originally written in the blues style. We now present the Bette Midler version of Miss Otis Regrets.
Welcome, Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, Desmond Howard, our special guest, Pete Carroll. Alabama out-muscling Texas right now, doubling him up on yardage. And the game plan for the Longhorns, short passes, McCoy running out the window, and he gets knocked out in the fourth snap.
Yeah, probably 65-70% of their game plan is out right now, you know, with Gilbert in the game. Alabama survived that, the first shaky things that happened to them, and they came back and held the field goals. That was a great start for those guys, and boy, they've taken over with the running game.
I think three just significant plays. And the goal line stand, McCoy's hurt, and then a bonehead call by your offensive staff for who the hell goes 15 seconds ago with the number one defense in the world?
Right.
Yeah, what a bonehead call that was.
Yeah, I just think the Alabama was a much more physical than Texas right now. Texas had the ball on the goal line. They were three and out. Alabama had the ball on the goal line. Mark Ingram virtually walked in untouched. They're much more physical up front right now than Texas is.
This is a tremendous challenge, you know, for Texas just to hold on right now until they can get going. They've got to figure out what's going on with their offense.
We'll come back. We'll talk about what, if anything, Texas can do with a true freshman quarterback to make up the 18-point deficit.
We started with over 1 billion colors. Generously added more than 2 million liquid crystal pixels. Combined 960 backlighting LEDs with 240 flawless scenes per second. made it 50% more energy efficient. And it all came down to one thing. The new 55-inch True LED from Vizio. Superior picture performance, superior price from America's number one LCD HD TV company.
Is there a rallying cry for the thinkers and doers of tomorrow? A motto that sums up their passion for creativity and their pursuit of discovery? Sure there is. Hook 'em horns. What starts here changes the world.
As athletes and students, they dreamed of victory and achievement. As soldiers and citizens, they dream of freedom and prosperity. But it's not about the dream. It's how you live that dream. So to the men and women of the armed forces, the Big 12 Conference and its 12 member institutions salute you. Thank you, because by living your dreams, you give us the freedom to live our dreams. The Big 12 Conference, live the dream.
ABC Thursday, January 21st.
Law school is history. We're first years, doormats, newbies, barely worth a partner's time, yet expected to perform flawlessly.
I keep it to myself.
I want to do good work, not at the expense of my principles.
Everybody says that at the beginning.
So will you switch bosses with me?
I'm partially naked here.
Oh, relax. I've seen hers and you're like my sister.
ABC's The Deep End premieres Thursday, January 21st at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
Alabama's thunder and lightning combo on the ground. This is the brilliant freshman from Pensacola, Trent Richardson, galloping untouched, 49 yards for a touchdown. Heisman Trophy winner Mark Ingram, 90 yards on 13 carries. Guys, they haven't converted a third down, Alabama, 0 for 5. McElroy's 2 for 4 looks unsettled, yet they're in total command.
Yeah, this is an easy game for Alabama right now. Judging from the way Texas is going at it with their offense, it's pretty easy. They just got to hold on to things and keep the good defense playing and run that football forever.
Texas has a problem.
Yes.
Alabama is much better than Texas right now without McCoy. Without McCoy. McCoy was the difference in the football teams, and they had a chance as well as McCoy plays. They have zero chance with Gilbert playing.
McCoy was a huge difference. Look at this offense without him. I think what they need to do now is to try to slow the Alabama defense down, maybe go to your draw game, throw some screens, try to get Jordan Shipley the ball fast and quick, slant routes, bubble screens, try to slow the Alabama defense down. That's the only chance I think they have right now.
Pete, with Gilbert in the game, 22 plays, 16 of them have gone for one or fewer yards.
Yeah.
What can they possibly do with this true freshman? He's going to be a good player, but not ready for this.
I think Desmond's on it. The thing that they have to do that is natural to this offense is to get the ball in the perimeter quickly and get it out. They're not doing that. They're dropping back with him in the gun and making it harder on a young quarterback. You want to get the ball out of his hands on the edge.
What would you tell them in the locker room, speaking to the seniors?
Right now for Texas, they have got to come back and just go back to work one play at a time. If they get crazy trying to win this game in the first couple drives, they'll get all screwed up. They got to go nice and comfortably after running their offense and see if they can find it. But they got to decide on what they want to do.
I think you tell them, look, we got here with pride. You got to have some pride now. Go out there and play. That's all they got to do. But the problem is McCoy is hurt, and he was there the whole team.
Well, Coach, PC hit it on the head. Don't forget now, Alabama won the toss. They took the ball. So coming out of halftime, Texas should get the ball. They're going to have to approach it one play at a time.
Yep.
Crawl your way back into this. It's not going to happen fast, but the defense, they're going to have to show up because it's easy being the number one defense in the country against the rush when you're in the Big 12 and there aren't teams committed and dedicated to running the ball, and they don't have the stable of running backs that you have in Alabama.
Right.
So now they got to bone up and stop the run.
Alabama has done a great job at the line of scrimmage blocking Texas.
Yeah.
Now they're running the football well. They're blocking people, so they've got a real chance to control this football game from this point. For you know, it's going to be very tough for Texas.
So Alabama, 30 minutes away from a national championship, if they can protect an 18-point lead against apparently a true freshman quarterback for Texas, a huge mountain for the Longhorns to climb here. This play at the end of the half built the big lead. The very talented Marcel Darius with a pick six. Second half coming up.
Verizon makes a big deal about their maps, but when you look a little closer, their story begins to fall apart. See, AT&T lets you talk on the phone while you surf the web. Verizon doesn't. AT&T has the most popular smartphones and the nation's fastest 3G network. Verizon doesn't. Glad that's cleared up.
Oh, AT&T, boy. A better 3G experience. Get an exclusive Pantech messaging phone free after mail-in rebate. Only from AT&T.
At the University of Alabama, we instill the minds of our students with the power to inspire others. From the quadrangle of an historic campus, across a state and beyond, spanning a nation and impacting the world. The University of Alabama, touching lives.
At the intersection of life and learning, you could conduct neonatal research, invent computer technologies, connect people, launch new products, increase longevity, improve the environment, prevent diseases, discover cures, develop new fuels and energy applications in national labs that lead the world. At the intersection of life and learning, find direction at the SEC and the SECAcademicNetwork.com.
Hello, I'm Ryan Cools.
And I'm Eric Dane with ABC's Grey's Anatomy.
Wounded Warrior Project provides programs and services for wounded service members like us during our recovery and rehabilitation. Our vision is to make this generation of wounded service members the most well-adjusted and successful in our nation's history.
It's my belief that all Americans have a duty to give back to those who've sacrificed so much for their country. I want to thank Citi, ESPN, and the Tournament of Roses for inviting us here today, and we encourage you to get involved. Visit www.woundedwarriorproject.org.
Well, let's take you down to the University of Texas Longhorn Band, directed by Dr. Robert Carnahan. Alabama leads it at the half, and we'll return for the second half of the Citi BCS National Championship after this from our ABC stations.
ABC Sunday, all new.
I had an affair.
All new year.
I'm Mexican.
The housewives bear it all.
Giving people what they want.
ABC's Desperate Housewives, all new Sunday at 9, 8 central on ABC. ABC next Thursday.
It's like we're going to L.A.
When two of television's biggest shows reunite, the sparks will fly. An all-new Grey's Anatomy private practice crossover event next Thursday starting 9, 8 central on ABC.
Hey, want to trade?
I got plenty.
No way.
I'll give you my lunch for a week.
Get your own.
Hand it over.
Larry, I'm your boss.
So?
Awkward.
Get your own Tuscan chicken melt. Fresh toasted with bubbly melted cheese. Surprisingly, 9 grams of fat. Part of a Subway Fresh Fit meal. A simple way to enjoy eating better. Subway, eat fresh.
Hey, Louie, don't you have a home? Why are you in my bathroom again?
Jack, I just want you to tell everybody how easy it is to have bath fitter install a new tub or shower in their own home.
Absolutely. All you got to do is tell everybody to thank Jack.
Just call one of us for an appointment.
After your phone call, we'll come to your home for a free consultation.
Then just kick back while we install your tub or shower.
You see, Louie, just think Jack. It's that easy. Now, this bathroom you've done is so beautiful. Why don't we get started on the one upstairs?
I'm here to buy a new Kia, please.
Here's your keys, and here's your cash.
Yes!
It's cash in a Kia at Paramount Kia. Just buy a new Kia, and we'll pay you cash.
I'm paying on my credit card.
Up to $8,000. While they last, new Kia Sorentos for just $244 a month, including Kia's 10-year, 100,000-mile limited warranty. Buy a new Kia, and we'll pay you cash. Up to $8,000. It's a fact. Kias cost less in Asheville, only at Paramount Kia.
Would you like to get up to a $1,500 tax credit, save up to 50% on your energy costs, all while going green and protecting the environment? Well, now you can. Our professionals at Glencoe Foam spray only the best insulation money can buy with the Isonene insulation system. The all-new bio-based LDR50 Isonene foam will seal every crack and crevice in your home and provide a healthier, quieter, more efficient way of living. Call Glencoe today to upgrade your existing home. Glencoe, preparing for the future.
Make your home more energy efficient. Call Glencoe Foam today.
Back to the second half of the Citi BCS National Championship Game. Herbie, let's take a look at our Citi inside view.
Well, this game started with Texas thinking that they had a pretty good chance when Alabama had a fake punt. Blake getting intercepted it. Colt McCoy's trying to get off to a good start. Then the big hit right there took him out of the football game and not only affected Texas and their offense with a young freshman Gilbert in the game, but it affected the flow of the game. Here's the same man, Marcel Darius, with his second big play of the first half, takes an interception into the end zone for a touchdown. And I also thought that Trent Richardson and Mark Ingram really started to take over the football game, 182 yards rushing in the first half. And right now, Texas gets the football to start the second half. You kind of get the feeling after that interception pick that was returned for a touchdown, they have to drive down and put some points up on the board.
Of course, I've been looking down as they took McCoy off. They took him back for an X-ray, and then without his pads, he walked back to the Longhorn locker room. His father, Brad, who was his longtime high school coach, went down to be with Colt inside the locker room, and you've got all kinds of tough decisions to make in this situation. When you've got a young man who's got a professional future ahead of him, he's got an injured shoulder, and you don't even know with that shoulder until you get back the X-ray whether or not a painkiller can help you in this situation.
Right, that's a good point. And I think it comes down to what they've been able to look at so far with the X-ray, the severity of that, and then they've got to make a decision. One thing I'll say, if the freshman continues to be out there, the game is just moving too fast. And then there's some of the other players coming around trying to give him some confidence. Sam Acho, a defensive end, talking to him, trying to build his confidence up. This young man's going to be a star down the road, but right now as a true freshman in the national title against a Nick Saban defense, the game is simply moving too fast. And you can see the struggles that they have had after Colt McCoy came in, or after Colt McCoy went down and Gilbert came in. They had three punts, the interception, another punt, and then his second interception return for a touchdown.
And Lisa, what do you hear down below?
Well,
Brent, I was just speaking to Mac Brown coming out of the locker room. Colt McCoy will not return to this game. So I asked Mac, how does your game plan change with the true freshman in under center? And he said, look, we just got to find something that he's able to do, simplify, so that we're able to get something out of our offense. He said that first half we just made way too many mistakes. I asked him, looking into your guys' eyes in that locker room, they had to be shell-shocked. What did you see? And he said, they're going to be all right. They're fighters. They're going to continue to compete. Guys.
Herbie, I want to go back to that last decision by the Texas coaching staff not to run the clock out at the end of the half. And Mac is right. The shuttle pass is not a high-risk play. It was not executed well. That made it high-risk when you had the freshman. So here is this play. And, Herbie, my question to you is, in that situation, would it have not been better to just run it out and go into the locker room?
I think they intended to do that. If you remember the first and 10 play, they picked up 9 yards, and I think it surprised them a little bit with Newton. And then they called a timeout to eventually set up a potential shovel pass. And then, as Mac told Lisa walking off, maybe a shot downfield. But I don't have an issue with the call. I have an issue with the idea after the game being dominated from the McCoy injury, trying to get points. I thought they would have just limped in at halftime down 17-6 and, you know, try to make some adjustments and get back into the game.
Well, now the entire team knows, and they can group around Gilbert. There's no doubts. McCoy will not be back for the second half. So you play on. Fielded back at the 9-yard line by Goodwin. And Goodwin is cut off. Got over to the 25-yard line. And he is one of those game-breaking speedsters who, if they can find the right play for Goodwin, they can help themselves a lot.
I think it's important for you and I and everybody watching to cut this kid some slack. He is a true freshman. He's very limited on how much experience he has. He's being asked to do next to the impossible and coming into a national championship. No matter how much talent he has, the game is moving fast for this young man. Let's watch to see how Greg Davis makes adjustments to help him here in the second half.
Got good genes. Daddy played 8 years in the NFL. Here comes Newton on first down. 9 yards on that first down run.
And you and I were talking towards the end of the first half. It's important for the leadership, the seniors that are around him. Ulatowski, Charlie Tanner, Chris Hall. These are all offensive linemen. You've got a great receiver in Jordan Shipley who's been around. These guys have to talk to him and let him feel that they believe he can lead them back in this game.
Here's Newton again, and hit by McClain. McClain is so savvy. One of the most intelligent linebackers in the country this year. He spends hour after hour watching tape of opponents. Watch him here.
I'm so glad you used the word intelligent, because he's really an extension of Nick Saban and Kirby Smart. He's like having a defensive coordinator out there as a 3-year starter, 6'4", 258 pounds, moving around out there and making plays like he's about 220.
Going to be a Sunday dandy, number 25. Third down and 2. And young Gilbert back with his first pass of this half and fires it for a first down. And that's to Shipley.
Great.
So there is a first down pass, and that'll pick up the young man's confidence.
And there's a great call. They're going to go with a hurry up here. This is usually where they might try to take a shot downfield here.
Garrett Gilbert, young man from Austin, has a tremendous upside. Incomplete. And he was under enormous pressure that time, Harvey.
The great thing that I've seen here early in this second half is I didn't like to see a young quarterback back there waiting and waiting and trying to read the middle of the Alabama defense. There's too much activity going on there for a young quarterback to try to decipher who's coming and who's going. Quick reads, get the ball out of his hands fast, and occasionally take a shot to the outside in one-on-one coverage.
Second down and 10. Fires, and Williams goes down for it, and that's a completion. And wave it off. I thought for a moment, but there is a penalty flag. And this could be a...
Looks like Williams might come up with that, but the ball obviously hits the surface. And here's Kareem Jackson again. Pretty good coverage from the big sophomore wide receiver.
So it looks like Chris Hall with a leg whip here. That's why they're marching it off against Mac Brown's Longhorns.
And Mack Brown just can't afford to see that. Chris Hall steps out of the game here. Have to keep a close eye on him. Now you're dealing with a backup center and a backup quarterback. Keep an eye on a center quarterback exchange, whether it's under center or in the shotgun. But Mack Brown can, and his offense cannot afford to have to execute second and 25.
Second down and 25. Snow replaced him. He snaps it. And incomplete. Kirkendall, number 11 underneath. And
Brent, that's what I'm talking about. When you wait for plays to develop, imagine, here comes the center. Welcome to the game. Welcome to the Alabama defense. He's trying to figure out who he needs to pick up. And when you're sitting in that pocket, the game is moving so fast, he's just trying not to make a mistake. And instead of getting back there, making a quick read and getting the ball out.
Third and 25. The flare and the outside to Goodwin with that speed. Picked up a first down. So there is the young speedster from Garland, Texas. Marquise Goodwin for 37 yards.
And every time Marquise Goodwin gets his hands on the football, you know that this is a possibility. Everybody in the stadium knew that a tunnel screen was coming on third and long, but they're able to hit it.
Coming right back up. Great block, Herbie, by Williams that time, too. First down and 10. Newton trips. It'll be second down. They give up a good yard on this play.
You can see Newton kind of looking up at the quarterback, Gilbert. And that's just a little thing there where you've got a backup quarterback. He's a little bit, maybe a little bit in front of where Colt McCoy might be. The rhythm of the handoff there, a little bit out of sync. And Gilbert ends up knocking down Trey Newton on that first down play.
Second and 12. And that was a false start. Illegal motion on the horns.
False start. Number 74, offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Dulatoski, fine left tackle. Rhythm of the game changes completely. Different cadence.
Yep.
Different centers. I mean, the whole thing starts to back up on you.
You and I love Rolando McClain. How about him? He is in total command. Nick Saban and Kirby Smart are yelling to him from the sideline, and within a second, he can make the adjustment to get the defense ready to go.
Pump fake. Far side, incomplete. Took a shot downfield at Goodwin. There is Kirby Smart, the defensive coordinator, and he is going to be in the next few days interviewing for the head coaching job at Texas Tech. Now, the Texas Tech president is here tonight watching this game. He happens to be an Alabama graduate. So Kirby Smart moves into the discussion as to who will be the next head coach over in Lubbock. Third down and 17.
Alabama will bring pressure here with an empty backfield.
Deflected, incomplete. And that was Mark Barron, one of the fine safeties on this great defensive unit.
Brent, I'm sorry. Anytime there's an empty backfield and you have third down and long, you bring one more than the offensive line can handle. And obviously, the quarterback has to get rid of the football quickly. And that time, Bama, great call there that time by Kirby Smart.
So security will be called to remove an idiot. And then we will continue here in the Rose Bowl. 24-6, and so discouraging, Herbie, for the Longhorns to lose Colt McCoy in the fashion they did right after. I mean, they had a turnover fake punt. They
had
were going
great,
in.
Great opportunity. Had all the momentum in the world they could ever hope for. The other thing that happens here is now to start the second half, they pick up a few first downs, looking like they might have a chance to get some points, get themselves to believe. And then the Alabama defense puts the clamps down. And Texas assisted there with some costly mental errors and mistakes as well.
So this is Gold, who has come on to punt this time for Texas. Into the end zone, it'll come out. Down to the 20-yard line. The tide rolling. They lead it 24-6 here in the third.
So I asked my dad where he wanted to go for his 60th birthday. Norway, he said, the land of our ancestors. We drank a pint at Ibsen's favorite pub. We sampled the local fare. We got new sweaters.
I feel like yodeling.
It was the trip of a lifetime, Dad said, until we went to the Hall of Records and discovered we were actually Swedish.
2 tickets to Stockholm, please.
Whatever your story is, your Citi card can help you ride it. Because Citi never sleeps.
Does your phone surf the web? Does your phone surf the web with the speed and power of a pro surfer at Pipeline? Does it bring you the web in all its glory, in all its intended pixels, allowing you to reach the farthest expanses of its universe, deepest depths of its oceans, without getting as much as a grain of sand in your shorts? Droid does. Wave-shredding web speed. In a world of doesn't, Droid does.
Right now, buy a Droid and get a Droid Eris free.
A work of art, a finely tuned machine, a sanctuary, a command center, a sophisticated sedan, a sports car. Nissan Maxima, the ultimate dual threat. Now get 2,000 cash back or 0% APR financing when you purchase a 2010 Maxima. Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Once upon a time, there was an island. There was an event that revealed a mystery that captured the world. But sadly, every great story must have an end.
Tuesday, February 2nd.
Survivors of the crash of Oceania.
The story that became a global phenomenon.
Dude.
Unlocks its final chapters. ABC's Lost. The final season premieres Tuesday, February 2nd on ABC.
College football in high definition is presented by Vizio.
We welcome you back to the Citi BCS National Championship with Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brent Musburger. Alabama leads it 24-6. They've got the ball back. Their fine quarterback, Greg McElroy, up under center. And Ingram with the carry. Acho makes the stop, and there is Colt McCoy coming back out with his father. Lisa reporting, of course, that he is not going to play in the second half, but wants to come out here with his team, and you never know.
Think about everything he's been through last year, the last play against Texas Tech, not getting a shot to get to the Big 12 title with the controversy, not having a chance to win the Heisman after a year, maybe the best year ever for a college quarterback. Getting back here this year and only to be hurt early.
Ingram is cut off again. Houston, big Lamar Houston was in there. So, you know, Greg McElroy overlooked in all of this discussion about Colt McCoy's injury and everything. And there is Mr. McElroy, who played football at Hawaii and now is in the front office of the Dallas Cowboys. He was also here with the Los Angeles Kings hockey team. He told me the other day that he never was able to relax. And I'm sure that's the case with most fathers who watch their sons in a game, especially of this magnitude. His son now ready in the shotgun, takes a snap. Underneath and short of the first down. And Ingram, the receiver that time. And that was Aaron Williams making the stop.
This Texas defense, considering it's the first time they've been out here, they're not giving up. I mean, they're still playing with an attitude. And to be honest, the Texas defense maybe has the best chance of getting Texas as a team back in the game.
And Shipley's a dangerous punt returner, and Alabama knows it. There's the fair catch signal at the 34-yard line. And so that's where Garrett Gilbert and the Longhorns will go back to work. That was a good stop by the Texas D, Herbie, just as you pointed out. So we'll take a break and come right back.
Before you ever love it, the Nissan Altima goes through over 5,000 tests.
No wonder it's ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power and Associates. It's quality you can love. Now lease a new Altima for $199 a month for 39 months or get $1,000 cash back.
Bravo Charlie, this is Echo Delta. I'm on fire.
Not too heavy, not too light. Bud Light. The difference is drinkability.
Call off the tanks.
We've secretly replaced this man's old car insurance with Esurance. Let's see what happens when he reads his statement.
Oh, yeah! Uh-huh, all right.
Apparently, saving money agrees with him. Switch and save discount only from Esurance. People seem to like it. Call or click today.
I've been working on this disease for 10 years. I think I can help your kids.
What would it take to prove your theory?
Inspired by a true story.
We have a deal. I care about more important things than money.
Don't tell me about more important things to care about.
A search for a cure.
We push ourselves. We work around the clock.
I already work around the clock.
A battle of wills.
Great. Cure diseases in theory, but never help a single human being in reality.
A dream worth fighting for.
Don't get your hopes up, kids. A Hail Mary.
Extraordinary Measures. Rated PG. In theaters January 22nd.
ESPN's coverage of the Citi BCS National Championship Game on ABC. Brought to you by Citi, proud to present college football's biggest game. Taco Bell, think outside the bun. Nissan Maxima, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy. And G2, half the calories, all the G.
Well, Kirk, we were in commercial. You had such a good point about Colt McCoy there on the sideline trying to urge his team on and talking to the young quarterback before he came out.
Yeah, he was urging everybody on, and he really was trying to encourage Gilbert to try to give him some confidence. Some of the things we had talked about earlier.
On first down, Gilbert. Brought down by Anders.
What you're talking about here in the, during the TV timeout, right in the middle of the offense, saying, hey, let's go right now, guys, let's go. These guys got to, they need a reason to believe that they can get back and be competitive.
Picked up five on that run, and now off the read option, throws. Williams puts it down, incomplete. Line judge ruled it incomplete.
Second time that Malcolm Williams has had the football in his hands, only to not come up with a catch.
Arenas appeared to be just a little shaken up there, didn't he? Yes.
Looks like he's going to try to get through it. Coaches say pound for pound, the strongest player on this Alabama defense. Well, that almost looked like a fumble, didn't it?
Third down and five. Fires right over the middle. Shepley for the first down to midfield.
He's in rhythm. There he gets back, and he makes a throw, and of course he gets a little bit of a rub there to open it up for Shipley underneath against man-to-man. But that time, Gilbert got back, took one hitch, and got rid of the football. That's what he's got to do.
There's that speed run again and going nowhere. DJ Monroe is hit by Lorenzo Washington.
Lorenzo Washington said, guys, eventually that's going to catch up to you. You can see from the DirecTV Ultimate Picture Cam, he just went right by the offensive line. Kyle Hicks, the right tackle, never had a chance because of the slant, the move to the inside by Lorenzo Washington, the senior.
Yeah, Kyle Hicks couldn't deal with him on that play. And it is second down and 15. Bama shows blitz. Middle fires incomplete. And Shipley coming across.
That is exactly the matchup that Texas would want, having Jordan Shipley throw the have a chance in one-on-one coverage with Justin Woodall. That's a mismatch. He's open. It's not like Shipley to join another party and drop the football.
Reamer may have got a finger on that ball. Seemed to change motion, and the linebacker was jumping at it. Third down and 15. Far side going deep, overthrows his intended target. It was Childs. That's John Childs.
John Childs, who moved over from quarterback to receiver, kind of gives up on the route at the top. It doesn't really look like he believes he's going to get a chance to get the football. He has got to get downfield, at the very least take Woodall with him, and then maybe that'll open up and open up something towards the middle of the field. Not a great effort that time by Childs.
Here comes one of the great punt returners. Obviously, Javier feels well enough to attempt to return this punt. And again, goal back out to punt. Javier Fair catches it at the 18-yard line. So the Texas D holding him in here in the second half. Now we'll see what can happen.
Let's talk about putting our best square foot forward. Then let's do more than talk about it. Let's turn picturing it into planning it. Thinking it over into making it happen. Let's say out with the old and in with the new. Let's create some wall-to-wall wow. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Right now, get any carpet installed for just $97. Any brand, any style, any number of rooms.
What if this year I got a new job? Added 800 minutes. Went hybrid.
Hey.
Added a dependent. And became a first-time home buyer. What if 2009 was my craziest year ever?
When life changes, an experienced H&R Block Tax Pro will find every deduction you've got coming. Click, call, or come over. H&R Block. Get it right.
It's the dawning of a new day for American business, and it's all because of you.
Look him in the eyes, smile. Hi.
Your ideas, your energy, and your dreams are the most precious resources we have, and OfficeMax is here to help you realize those dreams.
2010 is going to be our best year ever, and here's why.
OfficeMax, work with us.
A work of art, a finely tuned machine, a sanctuary, a command center, a sophisticated sedan, a sports car.
Nissan Maxima, the ultimate dual threat. Now get $2,000 cash back or 0% APR financing when you purchase a 2010 Maxima. Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy.
We welcome you back to the Citi BCS National Championship Game. Beautiful night in Southern California. Sellout crowd here. The Rose Bowl in Pasadena. Alabama looking for its first national championship since 1992 under Gene Stallings. They lead it here. Ingram. So we talk about young McElroy, and let's go back and review his history a little bit. Born right here in Los Angeles, became a huge Los Angeles Dodger fan. Then he moved to South Lake, Texas, about the fifth grade. He was a reserve quarterback behind Chase Daniel at Carroll High School. And then as a senior, lo and behold, they went unbeaten. He committed to Texas Tech, then made a visit to Alabama, fell in love with the school. His father's hero, of course, was Joe Namath. And the announcer, the quarterback, did that he'll come back and play his senior season. And got a little stoppage in play. There may be a cramp suffered by the Heisman Trophy winner. Ingram is up, coming off toward the sideline. He's played brilliantly here tonight. Rushed for 92 yards and a touchdown. And Greg Senior, like I said, was an offensive guard over at Hawaii Now, for the last 4 years, he worked in the Dallas Cowboys front office. But Joe Namath was his hero, and the Sun wears number 12 in honor of the Alabama legend who's out there. So many great players played for the Bear. Coming up now with Richardson. Fine tackle by Sergio Kendall. Another one of those fellas you're going to be seeing on Sunday. Number 2, big timer.
Now the game is dictating the play calling by Jim McElwain. He's kind of pulled it in a little bit since the Alabama team's been able to dominate on the other side of the football. But McElwain not asked to do a lot tonight. 3 of 5 for 39 yards. They've been winning this game with defense. And it's, again, he's managing the game and just trying to avoid a mistake to get Texas back in this football game.
The Colt McCoy injury turned everybody's game plan completely around. Third down and 12. Inside handoff and ridden down is the young running back hit by big Lamar Houston.
You know, I think you got to understand what Alabama's doing. They're working a little bit of clock. They're being conservative. They're being smart. They don't want to give Texas an easy turnover. But look, Lamar Houston almost ripped that football out. This will be a great look at it. He gets in there so quickly, and he's able to get a hand on the football. Look how close that ball came to coming out. I think he actually may have kept it against the thigh pad that time of Ingram.
Here's Fitzgerald back to Shipley again, a fair catch at the 46-yard line. So, freshman Garrett Gilbert will bring the horns out, working with a short field, and see if he can put some points on that scoreboard. Timeout.
Guarantee your savings with a Citibank CD. Go to citibank.com/CD.
AT&T is the nation's fastest 3G network, so you can download faster on your smartphone than Verizon. To prove it, I'm downloading myself on both networks at the same time. AT&T download's done. Verizon, sorry, your time's up. This AT&T download. Aye.
When you compare, there's no comparison.
Oh, no, this,
AT&T.
That's just not right.
A better 3G experience.
Get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate.
At Pizza Hut, we've got a deal for you. Choose any pizza, any size, any crust, and any toppings, and pay just $10. You want a large meat lover's pizza? $10. Maybe you're more of a large pan supreme kind of person? $10. Thinking of a combination of your own? That's $10 too. That's any pizza, any size, any crust, and any toppings for just $10. All your favorites, now just $10. Only at Pizza Hut.
Ted, you hooked up a new flat-screen TV to cable instead of DirecTV.
Yeah.
Would you shoot an epic with a camera phone?
Hmm.
Would you fill a Ferrari with cheap gas?
What?
It's a metaphor for DirecTV's superior picture quality.
Oh. So DirecTV makes my flat-screen better?
To get the most out of your high-def TV, you gotta hook it up to DirecTV.
Savings with a Citibank CD. Go to citibank.com/CD.
Our view from the DirecTV Ultimate Picture Cam here tonight on this lovely Southern California evening. The tide has been rolling ever since they trailed it by 6 points. And what is so very hard for Greg Davis right now with this offense, Herbie, is the fact that they never did establish a big-time running game this year. And now when you've got a freshman quarterback and you have to run, dial up the same plays, it makes it even doubly difficult. They'll try to run again and nothing doing. As we go down below for more on Colt, here's Lisa.
Well, Brent, I just spoke to Colt's father, Brad McCoy, who is now back up in the stands, and he obviously very concerned about his son. He said it doesn't appear that the shoulder injury is too serious. He said that the x-rays were negative, so that right now it appears to be a sprain, but they won't be able to confirm that until he's evaluated further. What Mr. McCoy told me is that Colt actually had been really begging the coaches and the trainers to let him go back into the game. He said he just wanted to give it a shot, to give his team everything that he had. But ultimately, everyone around McCoy, Mac Brown, the team doctor, his father, they all decided that it wasn't worth taking the risk, that he needs to be concerned and take care of his NFL future. Guys.
All right, thank you very much, Felicia. And on that play, Eric Anders, the defender for Alabama, had it read perfectly, and Newton couldn't hang on to the little swing. And so Texas now facing a third and 10. Gilbert has had four passes dropped here tonight, so certainly his receivers have not helped him a lick. Gilbert, incomplete. Williams, the intended target, he was well bracketed on the sideline.
Brent, that's what I was going to mention. One of the things when you face a Nick Saban defense is he's going to double a couple of your wide receivers, especially on third down situations. It's up to a quarterback that's experienced like Colt McCoy to find the single matchup and win that battle. Here with this young quarterback, he had probably made up his mind before the snap where he wanted to go with the football, and he threw it into double coverage.
This is gold to punt again. Arenas standing back on the 10-yard line. Into the end zone. It'll come out on the 20-yard line as we go to Chris Fowler.
Brett, this year's AT&T All-America Player of the Year is Colt McCoy from Texas. On behalf of AT&T, we'd like to congratulate Colt and thank all the college football fans out there who voted. The AT&T All-America Player of the Year is determined by the fans. Brett, back to you.
Chris, thank you very much. And clearly, those Texas Longhorn fans, they got the right number.
Yeah, no doubt about that.
No question.
Now, they've been running the football to the point where they're just settling for three runs and then a punt. I think they're gonna change it up here a little bit on this series.
And that is the fifth sack of the night of McElroy. Kendall rolls in.
I think maybe me and Will Muschamp were thinking the same thing. He comes off play action, and there's Sergio Kendall again. This defense is playing well, and Kendall is having a great game. That time he read it perfectly, and with his acceleration and closing speed, McElroy didn't have a chance at all.
For Sergio, that's 2.5 sacks. So now you must always account for him. He moves around to that defensive front. Locating him, that's your quarterback's job. Now they go back to Richardson, the freshman. Gideon, interception back in the first quarter, makes the stop.
Trent Richardson tonight, about 65 yards, averaging about 6.5 yards per carry. Such a great compliment to Mark Ingram this entire year. Roy Upchurch, the senior, also gets a chance from time to time, but really as the season wore on, it was the freshman out of Pensacola, Florida, who really did a great job of complimenting Ingram. And again, he's doing it tonight, had the big touchdown run.
Loosening up on the sideline. Third down for McElroy. Sergio was coming again. And this is Mays' first reception of the night, and he slips at the 19-yard line.
Well, he almost was able to hit a crease there and go a long way for Alabama, but much like what Texas has been doing on third down and long, just keeping it simple, trying to get it out to Mays to see if, again, he could try to hit a crease much like Marquise Goodwin did.
At some point, you got to try to block a punt when you're struggling the way Texas is.
A return a punt.
No matter how good Shipley is, this punter has been hanging it high. Yeah. Coverage has been all over Shipley. This is a big-time leg. There is another fair catch of a P.J. Fitzgerald punt. The only thing that Fitzgerald hasn't been able to do tonight is find the receiver on that fake punt. Well, five of the nation's brightest young lawyers will discover the real world requires more than a degree. ABC's The Deep End. That's a new series, and it premieres Thursday night, January 21st at 8, 7 central on ABC. That's The Deep End, Thursday night on ABC.
Let's see if Gilbert can continue to try to evolve right before our eyes and make some good decisions here on this drive for Texas.
They start off with the inside handoff. Trey Newton. Newton has rushed 13 times for 39 yards. Monroe coming around the edge three times for 33. Remember, he lost on the third one. Nothing doing. Just stoned right there in the middle. Big number 99, Josh Chapman. He and Terrence Cody.
And this defensive line and really the entire defense start to get into some predictable play calling. And they are, we've talked about it since he's been in there. They're really coming after him. Now you have a freshman quarterback on third down looking into this defense.
Now, I think everybody out there watching, now you know why Tim Tebow in Florida had so much trouble. Think about this defense that you're watching here tonight. Yes, a little bit easier with a freshman quarterback. There's no question about that. But consider, let's not take anything away from this Bama group. This is a sensational defense. There's Goodwin. He's got the speed. That's who they must use the rest of the way because of his breakout speed.
Marquise Goodwin and Shipley can get it going, and also DJ Monroe, because they can do it so quickly. Listen, again, you know what's coming on third down if you're Alabama. It's just a matter of being able to stop it. And that time, Kareem Jackson comes in late and tries to dislodge the football that time from Goodwin, but they're able to pick up the first down.
Klein moves over to the left, and it's deflected. Incomplete. Anders again, the senior from San Antonio, Texas, playing big against the Longhorns.
And Gilbert, as any young quarterback does, he's going to really stare down his wide receiver. And by doing that, this Alabama defense knows, number one, where the coverage needs to be. And then number two, it allows Anders to time it up and knock the ball away.
And those Bama defenders, that's a third tip pass when they read those eyes. Second down and 10. Gilbert going deep down the middle. Got a man, got Shipley. Touchdown, Texas! 44 yards. Gilbert to Shipley, who shook arenas. Shipley the holder, Lawrence out. Knocks it in.
Well, finally, you see Shipley make a play. The Alabama comes with the blitz, and Shipley's lined up right here, and he's one-on-one with Arenas. Great move here to the outside. He gives him just a little bit of a look. It's enough to give him an edge, and the most important thing there is the pass protection. He had time to evaluate, and when you have a double move like that, how about this Texas offensive line? They do a good job of picking up the blitz from McClain and Barron. Just enough time to be able to get the ball downfield. It's the timing up in the left. You see the eyes of the young quarterback making the read. Good job up front. And when Shipley finally is able to separate and get away from Arenas, how about the true freshman putting the ball on the money for the touchdown?
And Colt McCoy on the sideline over there with the freshman who threw the touchdown pass. Herbie, I'm going to make a point now. How big is that play at the end of the first half right now when you look at this score that was intercepted on the shovel pass and taken in for an Alabama touchdown? That play will haunt. Now they get the onside kick, and they dive for it. Texas! No quitting the horns.
No, this Let's give a lot of credit to the Texas defense. I said it in the first series to start this second half, that they did everything that they needed to do as their young quarterback and the offense was struggling. They kept Alabama's offense pinned back inside their own 20-yard line until eventually Gilbert makes a play to Shipley to get a little bit of momentum going. And then on special teams, they catch a break. And again, great field position for Gilbert. And now he's got a little bit of confidence. And more importantly, the players around him have confidence too.
What a great kick. Ricochet off the Alabama player, Brad Smelly. And then recovered by the Horns. Now they line up quickly. Gilbert's got a field, got a man open on the far side. Shipley's up in the air, and he's covered incomplete. Jackson is the defender who's there. Not on my watch, Jackson says.
Yeah, Jackson's out there one-on-one. The ball needs to be thrown just a little bit. See how Shipley has to slow down? And more often than not, an official will call that pass interference because Jackson has his back turned to the play, and he's not making an effort to find the football. He got away with one there.
Second and 10. That screen to Shipley. And nothing doing on that play. And Alabama jumped all over number 8. And Mark Barron, their safety, led the way.
Barron, a lot like Rolando McClain, you might get it once or twice, but if you try to go back again to a play that's been successful, they're starting to pick up on that. That time, Barron read that very quickly and was able to accelerate and make the play.
Bama shows blitz. On third down, got one-on-one, far side, incomplete. They want the penalty flag. They're just not getting any help on that far side. Williams, defended by Jackson. Take a look, Kirby.
We'll take a close look because Malcolm Williams has had a rough night holding on to the football. And Jackson has pretty good coverage. He's pretty fit. Ball is in the air. And there's contact. They brought the safety blitz, Robbie Green.
Are you kidding me?
There's contact. The ball's in the air right in front of the Texas bench. Jackson gets away with a couple there within a three-play sequence.
And Alabama will get it back. Gold the punter. It's going to be down at the 6-yard line. A little reminder now for Coast to Coast, you get the latest news from the teams you care about. The power of ESPN covering Boston, Chicago, Dallas, and now Los Angeles. And now with local flavor, a Sports Center segment just for you on ESPNLosAngeles.com.
Remember this Texas defense in the second half. They've been able to take advantage of Jim McElwain calling a conservative game plan. Now they're backed up inside their 10-yard line. Texas has momentum. Will they get more aggressive? Will they continue to be predictable, allowing this Texas defense to force a 3-and-out to get the football in great field position?
Richardson stays in. And they bounce the freshman straight ahead.
Think about Alabama. Even though they're running the football and Texas knows it's coming, they ran the football in the first half almost at will on certain drives when Texas knew it was coming. So give credit to Will Muschamp and this Texas defense for coming out, being down 24-6 and not giving up and still playing with a lot of heart.
Alabama had 3 possessions in the third quarter, all of them 3-and-out. And now we will come to the money quarter with Bama leading 24-13. And this presentation of the Citi BCS National Championship returns after this message and word from our ABC station.
Down. Derek Thompson didn't believe in dreams.
I'm gonna play hockey just like you.
Lower your expectations.
And he didn't believe in fairy tales.
The tooth fairy's gonna visit me tonight.
There's no such thing as a...
Derek.
Until he became one.
You are ordered to serve as a tooth fairy.
Help, please!
On January 22nd...
Get him into flying school.
The tooth...
You might be the worst tooth fairy ever.
...is loose.
Who are you?
I'm the tooth fairy.
Whatever.
What?
What? Oh, yeah.
Tooth fairy. Rated PG. Before you ever love it, the Nissan Altima goes through over 5,000 tests. No wonder it's ranked highest in initial quality by J.D. Power and Associates. It's quality you can love. Now lease a new Altima for $199 a month for 39 months or get $1,000 cash back.
I'm Dr. Love. This is Dr. Pepper Cherry. It has a kiss of cherry flavor. This devilish elixir has a kiss
Dad.
Of cherry.
Dad, it's not kiss. It's kiss of cherry. It's amazingly smooth. Be smooth.
Dr. Pepper Cherry is amazingly smooth.
Trust me, I'm a doctor.
I lost 54 pounds by reducing my daily calories and replacing my usual fast food with Taco Bell's drive-thru diet. That's 7 delicious items all under 9 grams of fat. When I decided to trim down, I knew I had to be realistic with myself. I didn't want to cut out my fast food, so I started choosing Fresco items from the drive-thru diet menu. These results aren't typical, but for me, they're fantastic.
The Taco Bell drive-thru diet. Hear Christine's amazing story and download a coupon for a free Fresco taco at drivethroughdiet.com.
ABC Wednesday, Modern Family is Golden Globe nominated on every top 10 list and the comedy you can't take your eyes off of.
You know I can see you, right?
No, I did not know that.
Modern Family, all new Wednesday, 9, 8 central on ABC Comedy Wednesday.
Why Honda? I've got my reasons, a whole carload of them.
My Honda, it gives me a good feeling about the road ahead.
Solid safety and real economy.
Lowest cost of ownership and the best value for my Honda dealer.
Get a Pilot or Odyssey, now with low 1.9 financing, or CRV, now just $249 a month.
This may be the smartest investment I've ever made.
Honda confident for the road ahead.
Right for today. Designed to last and last.
See your Honda dealer of the Carolinas today.
Make your home more energy efficient. Call Glencoe Foam today.
We welcome you back to the Citi BCS National Championship Game. The Rose Bowl, Pasadena, California. Big series here for Alabama. They've gained only 3 yards in the second half. Just three against this Longhorn D. Richardson continues to play, and he picks up a first down. Now let's check in with Tom Rinaldi about Mark Ingram. What's the story?
Well, Brett, the training staff has worked on him 15 straight minutes. He never let go of his helmet trying to get in. They've used ice. They tried to hydrate him using Gatorade, pickle juice, etc., but haven't been able to knead out those calf muscles to the point where he could return to the game. He's clearly anxious to do so, though, Brent.
It's having the freshman backup, Richardson, just hammered for a big first down. He is directly behind Greg McElroy. Coming again. Robinson, but he needed help from his friends. That young man is as powerful as Ingram, it looks like.
Yeah, absolutely. You put him in a weight room and you'd be sitting there in awe. He's just a guy that has tremendous power, low center of gravity, tough to bring down. We talked a lot about him tonight, how he's a great complement to what Mark Ingram can do. And Alabama working a little bit of clock, continuing to run the football. They've got to be careful, though, again, of being too predictable. But at the same time, deep in their own territory, they don't want to take too many chances.
Second and 7, McElroy is going to throw out, incomplete, and it'll be third down. Upchurch had slipped out of the backfield.
Anytime Roy Upchurch gets into the football game and lines up at fullback, you should know as a defense that number five, is chances are he's going to go out to the flat or he's going to be out in the open somewhere trying to catch the football. Great hands. In fact, he had the big touchdown catch late in the game against Auburn to secure that victory in the Iron Bowl. So great talent. They like to use him. You know, he's listed as a tailback up at fullback to try to surprise defenses.
Alabama is 0 for 8 on third down. Here comes number 9. McElroy, there's a penalty flag. Throws over the middle. Picks up the first down. Richardson, but there is a penalty flag thrown by the side judge.
I think it's offsides defense. Decline this penalty.
Offside defense number 2. Penalty's decline. Resulting play is a first down.
It's not just picking up first downs, but when you're down by 11, every first down that you allow allows Alabama to continue to eat clock, continue to keep the football away from Texas. And just when they had a little bit of momentum and Alabama hadn't had any first downs in the second half, Bama feels that heat, and they come back with a couple big first downs in their own territory.
Play fake on first down. McElroy going to go deep for Mays. Mays, penalty flag. The field judge called the flag. One of those underthrown balls, I believe, in which the defense gets victimized.
Pass interference. I'm rating the defense. 15-yard penalty and automatic first down.
I love this. Another great call here on first and 10 when it looks like you're starting to just run the football and work on the clock. You try to lull the defense to sleep, and there's a little bit of pushing going back and forth on both sides. And I think on first and 10, like Brent, for Greg McElroy, that's probably his most comfortable down to throw the football. He got the matchup that he wanted. He just overthrew it, but he caught the first down with the pass interference.
McElroy ready again. Here's Richardson. And another penalty flag flies after the tackle by Houston.
Texas over there celebrating for a holding call, but we'll have to wait and see. Maybe it's...
Crews having a little bit of trouble.
Yeah,
personal foul.
Obviously.
Number 2 of the defense.
That's
hands
Sergio
to the face. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
I think he struggled here to try to get off of the block of James Carpenter. Gets his hand up in the face right there. I think it's that one late where he grabbed the hold of the face mask. I think Texas felt they had a holding call on Sergio, but instead it goes the other way.
Not happy. First down across the 40-yard line. Richardson almost came out of that pile, didn't he? Big Lamar Houston wouldn't let him. Second down. Texas must stop them here early in the fourth quarter. You know, if you were looking at a statistical difference between Mac Brown's team and Nick Saban's, you would have looked at the penalty charts. And here tonight, that is showing up again. Coming into this game, 180 fewer penalty yards against Alabama over the course of the season. Tonight it's 67-23. Alabama with the fewer penalty yards. So that difference shows again as Richardson loses his helmet.
It's Texas defense here on second down, locked in on Richardson. Gideon this time, and Ernest, the backup to McElroy, who's been in there most of the second half, able to get pretty physical, get him back into an Alabama, back into this third down.
So here it is, third down and five.
Brent, as you mentioned, Bama's converted only one third down tonight.
Going to try to throw for it. Incomplete. Mays was coming back and appeared to slip. Let's say it was Julio Jones on that far side who slipped.
He's trying to give a little bit of a look to Williams, like he's going to go downfield. They both slipped. They both slipped. And you know, I've heard a lot about, you can help me here, the ryegrass. They said it's slick. It's overseeded to try
evening.
To, yeah, yeah.
A little bit of that fog in the air, along the Pacific coast there. Here's Tiffin with a 52-yard attempt. Missed it. Texas stays alive.
Hanging around.
Barely.
But they're hanging.
But they're breathing.
Half the calories,
all the day.
Half the calories,
all the day.
I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. Float like a butterfly. I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. Sting like a bee. I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sting like a bee.
Half the calorie, all the G.
I know that's right.
You have multiple cars and multiple toys with multiple places to go. So be smart, simplify, combine, and save. Get all your insurance from one Allstate agent, and you can get multiple discounts on your multiple policies. Simpler is smarter. That's Allstate stand. Are you in good hands?
Walk right in, sit right down. Baby, let your hair hang down. Walk right in, sit right down.
Casey Kane here. Enter the ultimate man cave makeover at greatclips.com.
Great Clips.
ABC Thursday, January 21st, from the network that brought you Grey's Anatomy.
Will you switch bosses with me?
I'm partially naked here.
Oh, relax. I've seen hers and you're like my sister.
Five of the nation's brightest legal minds will discover the real world requires more than a degree.
Let's not make that a thing.
You guys are brilliant.
Don't feed them. Makes them unmanageable.
ABC's The Deep End, series premiere, Thursday, January 21st at 8, 7 central on ABC.
ESPN, the new home of the BCS.
SportsCenter, join us after the game. We're live with Pete Carroll and our game day crew for a complete breakdown of tonight's BCS title game.
John Anderson, Scott Van Pelt. Hope you'll join us on ESPN.
Vince Young and Colt McCoy side by side. They were side by side 4 years ago here when Vince staged that dramatic fourth quarter victory over USC. Now they are on the sideline. And they're going to go empty. Texas has Goodwin split out to the right. Gilbert will come underneath. Shipley makes a very fine catch on a first down. And Herbie, he's getting a little more comfortable throwing the ball here.
I think he's settling down. And Greg Davis has done a good job of adjusting to what he's more comfortable with, how they're going to attack the Alabama defense. And you and I, at the break, both agree. Marquise Goodwin, Jordan Shipley, these guys have the ability to hit a crease in man-to-man coverage, and they can take it to the house and put you right back in a position to have a chance to compete in this game.
Goodwin is at the top of your screen, not looking in that direction, throwing, coming out of the backfield. For what a terrific catch there by Trey Newton.
Well, Trey Newton has a bright future for this Texas offense as a running back. People are very critical of their inability to run the ball, but I don't think that's a reflection necessarily of Newton. I think he's going to be a great player.
There's a penalty flag.
There's no penalty on the play prior to the snap. The previous play is under review.
Well, it gives us a chance to appreciate the effort by Newton. We're going to go back and look at this. It happened pretty quickly. Goes down and gets his fingertips on the football. And I think they want to just see, as he landed on his hip, did the ball touch the surface or was he able to protect the football? So this will be probably the best look at whether or not the ball's secure. Based on the looks that we just saw, that play should stand and should set up a third and short.
You know, Herbie, we have a moment. We need to congratulate the Rose Bowl folks on the two games that they've had here. As you look down tonight, 94,906. Our great crowd. Of course, we were jammed for Ohio State's victory over Oregon. So it'll be third and short.
Now you got to believe the quarterback sneak is coming, and big Terrence Cody will be in the middle of this. This is not Terrence Cody's kind of game, defending a spread offense, but anytime they go quarterback sneak or short yardage, the big fella can get involved in a game plan.
Avoid the mountain. Try to find a pass. Third down and one. That's not high percentage when you go in there. And there's a penalty flag this time.
We got Alabama this time.
Offside?
Trying to jump the gun a little bit. Wondering why all the white jerseys went backwards.
Offside. Nose guard. Defense. 5-yard penalty. Results in a first down.
Can't miss him. Look at it.
It's actually,
Looks like McClain stuck over the.
McClain had cheated up into that.
Right.
In between the guard and center, just trying to shoot a gap, and it worked, but he just jumped a little bit early. All right, let's see if Gilbert can get this offense going again. Looking for Goodwin and Shipley.
Has time and couldn't find a receiver quickly enough. He brought down Washington again, and it will be second down. Boy, it can close so quickly when that door starts to slam.
He's looking off to his left to Shipley, but Shipley's unfortunately trying to go up against Kareem Jackson, and he can't shake it. Kareem Jackson is all over him, and eventually there's nothing that the young quarterback, Garrett Gilbert, could do with the football.
Complete to the 46-yard line, and that time he did find Shipley, who was double covered, threw it well.
That is a lot of traffic in there to the middle of that Bama defense. They've had a lot of success on third down with the tunnel screen. The last time they tried to run it, Mark Barron did an excellent job of reading the play and jumping it and taking it away. But they have hit a couple big ones to Marquise Goodwin. Maybe a good time to fake it to Goodwin and maybe try to go to the tunnel screen on the other side.
May have been a false start in the middle.
False start. Number 63 offense. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Michael Huey.
They're either going to roll the quarterback out away from the pressure, kind of moving the launching point for Mac Brown, or just get the ball out of his hands quickly with some type of screen. You don't want him sitting back there in that pocket with this Alabama defense on a third down.
Got to hurry. Got it off. And fires a beautiful ball to Shipley for a first down. Barron was the defender, and it was a fine throw to Shipley for 13 yards.
All of a sudden, Garrett Gilbert's looking like a seasoned veteran, walks up, sees the coverage that he wants, makes a little adjustment, gets the match up to Shipley, and calmly steps up, maneuvers well in the pocket, and makes a nice throw to Shipley for the first down.
Under pressure, quickly reads it, incomplete. Got it off though when he saw the heat coming.
Well, that's okay. I mean, when you're not only trying to execute, you're also trying to work with the clock. Here comes McClain closing in on him. I mean, imagine if he showed up at this stadium today, looking around at the San Gabriel Mountains and cheering on old Colt, thinking about, boy, Colt, you're gonna go out in style, win a national championship. All of a sudden, second series. Hey, rookie. You're in the ball game. Let's go. And now he's out there looking into the eyes of Orlando McClain.
Here's Gilbert with time. Steps up into his throw. They've got another first down with Shipley.
Well, Shipley's starting to feel pretty comfortable here, going up against this defense and getting some matchups in his secondary where they can take advantage of his quickness. This time it was against Mark Barron. Earlier it was against Justin Woodall.
I believe Shipley has a fabulous future as a slot receiver in the National Football League.
He's a Wes Welker type of guy in the NFL.
Question. First and 10. Quick strike to the outside, and Buckner's upended.
Alabama is doing everything that they can to disrupt the rhythm that this young quarterback Gilbert has all of a sudden found. This time they decided to bring Arenas on a blitz, so it's a different looks. They're sitting rushing three and dropping eight, and other times bringing pressure, but the young man continues to read the defense properly and making good decisions with the football. But he's got to finish this drive.
Second down and 13. Whitaker becomes one of his receivers. He is split out to the left as they spread the field. Gilbert got a man open. Touchdown, Texas. Shipley's second of the night. A freshman growing up before your eyes. 28 more yards.
He saw one-on-one coverage with his best receiver against Robbie Green, the sophomore. There was some confusion in the secondary from Alabama. You could see Green in the background turning around. He thought he had safety help. And how about the freshman recognizing the one-on-one coverage? Puts it up in the air where Shipley can make the catch. His 10th catch of the night for 122 yards and two touchdowns.
Going for two. Middle, got it, complete, Buckner. A comeback for the ages, perhaps. But now it is up to the champions of the SEC. And they will gather around an unbeaten quarterback following this two-point conversion. Greg McElroy has not lost a football game as a starting quarterback since the eighth grade. He's under the gun next.
Excuse me, is this the
returns line?
Yeah.
Didn't get the 3G coverage you wanted this season? There's a map for that. To get almost five times more 3G coverage than AT&T, hurry into the Verizon Wireless Go Red Save Green event, where you can get 50% off select 3G phones like the Moto Rival, LG 8360, or the Samsung Omnia for just $24.99. Verizon Wireless.
So I asked my dad where he wanted to go for his 60th birthday. Norway, he said, the land of our ancestors. We drank a pint at Ibsen's favorite pub. We sampled the local fare. We got new sweaters.
I feel like yodeling.
It was the trip of a lifetime, Dad said, until we went to the Hall of Records and discovered we were actually Swedish.
Two tickets to Stockholm, please.
Whatever your story is, your Citi card can help you write it. Because Citi never sleeps.
Rated R. In theaters tomorrow.
They don't like commuting, but they're excellent drivers. They completely ignore the escalator. And even though they live like there's no tomorrow, they already have plans for tomorrow. Whee! Big plans. That's the ultra life. Michelob Ultra. 95 calories, 2.6 carbs, and exceptionally smooth taste. It's the superior light beer, perfectly balanced for the ultra life.
ESPN's coverage of the Citi BCS National Championship Game on ABC. Brought to you by Citi. Proud to present college football's biggest game. Warner Brothers Pictures' Edge of Darkness, starring Mel Gibson, in theaters everywhere January 29th. Dr. Pepper, drink it slow, doctor's orders. And the Home Depot, more saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot.
Well, just when you thought the coach's trophy presented by Dr. Pepper was on its way to Tuscaloosa, the Texas Longhorns have fired back. Jordan Shipley had only one catch in the first half for 5 yards. In the second half, he's had nine catches for 117 yards and two touchdowns. The short kickoff again. Fair catch at the 34.
Brent, we talked about Bama's going to take some chances and bring blitzes. It's going to leave Shipley right here one-on-one with a safety and Robbie Green. There's some confusion. Green ends up coming up. I think he expected Woodall to be over the top to help him out. And how about the hit that Garrett Gilbert takes right here by Courtney Upshaw, showing his toughness. And who's his number one fan right now? The starting quarterback, Colt McCoy, cheering him on.
Greg Davis calling plays, and now the Heisman Trophy winner Mark Ingram returns for Alabama. Number 22 is back in the backfield. Alabama scoreless here in the second half. Texas has put 15 points in this comeback bid since the intermission, scoring their first touchdowns of the game in the second half. Play action, McElroy, first down, drops it in underneath to Ingram. Ingram out to the 41-yard line. McElroy back on the field as the linebacker, Herbie.
And Jim McElroy now is going to try to mix up and try to maintain the balance that they had tried to have earlier in the first half. They've been very, very conservative with the big lead, probably anticipating that their defense could hold on even with the conservative game plan on offense. But all of a sudden, the freshman, Garrett Gilbert, has caught fire. Now Alabama's got to get back to being more aggressive with their play calling.
Ingram bounces outside. You can't bring him around down on the ground alone. You need help.
A junior college transfer, James Carpenter, who has had a great night tonight, sealing the edge, comes up with another great block. You also have the big tight end, Colin Peak. And again, when you allow Mark Ingram to build up some momentum and get to that second level of the defense, very, very difficult to slow him down.
He's pounded for 111 yards here tonight and one touchdown. And just like against Auburn and Florida, the Tide begins to mount a big-time drive. But can they finish it? Ingram again. Got about a yard. Sam Acho.
Should mention it, McElroy back on the field playing. Dustin Ernest had played for him most of his second half, and McElroy, an important leader to have out on this field.
Ingram's mom watching there in the middle, the black and white coat, Flint, Michigan. Second and nine. Ingram again, cut off, trying to run to the left that time. And McElroy again.
McElroy, now that he's back out there all over the field, and this is a huge second down, Brent, because what Texas wanted to try to do here is get to Ingram and get Greg McElroy into a third and long, where they've got an advantage with Alabama only converting one of 10 third down attempts.
Third and eight. Too much time. Incomplete. Aaron Williams, the defender.
Will Muschamp always says, I want to affect the quarterback. Look at Greg McElroy losing ground. You see how he doesn't trust what he is seeing? It's because of what Muschamp is doing, creating confusion. He has nowhere to go with the football. But when you see a quarterback losing ground, that's what Will Muschamp means when he says, I want to affect the quarterback.
Fitzgerald versus Shipley again.
And a half, Texas.
So the Longhorns use a timeout here. We'll take a break. 3:21 left, and you're watching the Citi BCS National Championship on ABC.
The 40th day, rated M for mature.
Introducing the 2010 Motor Trend Truck of the Year, the all-new Ram Heavy Duty. With a legendary 6.7-liter Cummins turbo diesel, an all-new refined interior, it gives brains more to think with, it gives muscles more to work with, it gives trophy shelves more to deal with. Introducing the 2010 Motor Trend Truck of the Year, Ram.
Let's talk about putting our best square foot forward. Then let's do more than talk about it. Let's turn picturing it into planning it. Thinking it over into making it happen. Let's say out with the old and in with the new. Let's create some wall-to-wall wow. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Right now, get any carpet installed for just $97. Any brand, any style, any number of rooms.
Hi, is Denise working?
Yeah, she's in the back. Can I take your order?
I'm just a little bit more comfortable ordering with Denise.
Bye.
Hey, hi, you remember me? I came by yesterday, gave me that five-layer burrito, that new one for
89 cents.
Is that cool? Is that still cool?
It's an inside deal for everyone. Layers of seasoned beef, cheddar cheese, and a hidden layer of nacho cheese sauce. It's Taco Bell's new beefy five-layer burrito for just 89 cents. Why pay more?
We welcome you back to the Citi BCS National Championship. With Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brett Musburger. Texas rallying in the second half, trails it by three. 45 points on our board tonight. And Shipley, who has scored their two touchdowns, goes back deep. A high, beautiful punt. Shipley will have to go for the fair catch at the 7-yard line. Here's young Garrett Gilbert.
Yeah, Garrett Gilbert came into this game late, as you would expect. He's forced in because of the injury. The game was moving fast. They were pressuring him. not seeing open receivers. All of a sudden, he started to settle down. The defense gave him a reason to believe with good field position. Offensive line giving him time to throw. And I think this throw to Shipley really ignited his confidence and started to make him believe that he had the goods and he had what it takes to be able to lead this offense. But now he finds himself deep in his own territory to try to make some adjustments. What a change of events. 4 of 22. Look at his last 14 throws, hitting 10 passes.
Travis High in Austin, Texas, led them to two state championships. From his own end zone. Middle, incomplete, and there's a penalty flag. Mark Barron working in the secondary.
Mark Barron holding on to Kirkendall. Looks like defensive holding to me.
Holding. Number four defense against an eligible receiver. 10-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
We should note that with a young quarterback back there, how about this Texas offensive line? There it is. I mean, Barron clearly holding on to Kirkendall. This Texas offensive line, the same line that gave up 9 sacks against Sioux in Nebraska, they haven't given up a sack tonight.
Down toward 3 minutes. Gilbert fumble. Ball's loose. Bama's got it. At the 3-yard line. The defense for the Crimson Tide.
Great time to call the blitz. Eric Anders comes off the left edge of the offense, the blind side. And just when I said they haven't given up a sack, Alabama dials up the blitz, and Anders makes it home, his 6th sack of the year.
Upshaw recovers it. Anders coming in unmolested, and Gilbert never felt it. The young man by way of San Antonio, Texas, lights up the Longhorns in the final 3 minutes. He's played a brilliant football game. Mount Cody, the lead fullback. Here's Ingram to the 2, and it will be second down and goal.
Important for Texas not to lose their swagger here. I know it's a big turn of events, but Alabama in these situations, they've not always been able to capitalize and score touchdowns in the red zone. It's something that has haunted Greg McElroy and the Crimson Tide offense. You know they're going to come in there with the big running back, Mark Ingram, but Texas, if they're able to hold them to a field goal, obviously they're still right in this football game.
Cody, the lead fullback, he'll set down in front of Ingram. Ingram stopped. It'll be third down and goal from the 1-yard line.
Looks like Texas is going to try to use one of their timeouts, and you go back to that substitution mistake that they had when they didn't have enough men on the field. They had to burn a timeout.
We'll take a break and come back for the final 2:06.
So I asked my dad where he wanted to go for his 60th birthday. Norway, he said, the land of our ancestors. We drank a pint at Ibsen's favorite pub. We sampled the local fare. We got new sweaters.
I feel like yodeling.
It was the trip of a lifetime, Dad said, until we went to the Hall of Records and discovered we were actually Swedish.
2 tickets to Stockholm, please.
Whatever your story is, your Citi card can help you write it. Because Citi never sleeps.
Bet you're one of those multitaskers who wishes you could talk on the phone and surf the web at the same time. AT&T's 3G network lets you do that. Verizon's doesn't. Actually, you can talk on the phone and surf the web with Verizon, but you just need 2 phones to do it.
Yeah, I got it.
Sorry. Can I give you a hand?
Thank you. Hello? Yeah. I'm still waiting for it to download.
When you compare, there's no comparison.
Yeah, I'm going to type it in again.
AT&T, a better 3G experience. Get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate.
Did you shoot my daughter?
Kramer!
Welcome to hell.
This is someone armed and dangerous.
What do you think I am?
You are out of your depth and far from your jurisdiction.
My daughter was Emma Craven.
I'm not gonna arrest anyone.
Edge of Darkness.
I'm the guy with nothing to lose. Fasten your seatbelt.
Rated R. Starts January 29th.
A work of art. A finely tuned machine. A sanctuary. A command center. A sophisticated sedan. A sports car. Nissan Maxima. The ultimate dual threat. Now get 2,000 cash back or 0% APR financing when you purchase a 2010 Maxima. Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy.
This is our chance to change things. This is our destiny.
And if you're wrong, then everyone on the island dies.
The answers are coming. ABC's Lost, the final season, premieres Tuesday, February 2nd on ABC.
Well, the DirecTV drive to the national championship bus has completed its season-long journey, and now the Crimson Tide of Alabama trying to complete their season-long journey. Undefeated and within 1 yard of putting Texas away with a third and goal and 2 minutes remaining. Cody leads Ingram. Ingram battles, second effort, touchdown. His second of the night. Shonda, his mother. And we hope that Mark Sr. was able to watch. He, of course, has been incarcerated up in New York. He's awaiting final sentencing. He stays in constant touch with Mark. Passes along coaching tips to him through mom. And when we talk about all the Heisman Trophy winners who have struggled in the BCS championship game, you will not include Mark Ingram in that list. He came up huge here tonight. Shook off a hamstring cramp. Whatever it was down on the sideline.
Yeah. And the touchdown, very fitting way for Alabama to put the seal on this, because you said it, second effort from Mark Ingram. And how many times in 2009 have we seen that very thing by Ingram? Initially feels a little bit of a presence from Texas, but fights through the corner Aaron Williams and eventually lunges in for the you would think, again, the touchdown that puts this out of reach for Texas. And in a night where they got conservative, didn't ask a lot from Greg McElroy, ended up 6 of 11 for 58 yards, they turned to the running game and the tandem tonight of Ingram and Richardson.
Senior Lee Tiffin. They await the review upstairs. Didn't seem to be much doubt. Did you think, Herbie?
No, I think probably just to be safe.
After further video review, the ball breaks the goal line plane prior to either knee hitting the ground. It is a touchdown.
So here's Tiffin. Fitzgerald will put it down. Tacks on another point. 2 minutes away from a national championship.
They dialed up the blitz at the right time, created some confusion on the left side of the Texas offensive line. Upshaw comes up with it inside the 5-yard line. And 3 plays later, the big guy, the Heisman Trophy winner from 2009, Mark Ingram, into the end zone and puts the Tide up by 10.
And over on the side, I'm enjoying that. So Texas turned it over three times, and Alabama scored 14 points. One intercepted pass for a touchdown, and there are so many outstanding players on this Bama defense, you hardly know where to begin. Marcel Darius, he intercepted the ball, ran for a touchdown, knocked Colt McCoy out of the game. Lorenzo Washington came up big. Eric Anders moments ago. Orlando McClain has played big all night long. Corey Reamer on that blitz. One after another, and many of them are coming back next year. And with this win, Herbie, I predict that Alabama in some polls will go off as the preseason number one.
I don't know how they can't be. With the players that they have coming back, Dante Hightower will be back from his injury. They'll probably lose McClain to the NFL, but I'm with you. I don't know how you can't have him up at number one with everything they have coming back.
Well, a reminder now that ESPN will kick off Super Bowl week in South Florida on Sunday, January 31st. McDonald's presents the 2010 Pro Bowl. How's that for a doubleheader? Go down to Miami, watch the Pro Bowl, stick around for a week, and catch the Super Bowl.
You a fan of the way they've moved the Pro Bowl?
I like it when it's in Hawaii myself. But I think, you know, for a little change of pace,
yeah,
and for the business it's going to bring to South Florida.
What do you do with all the players in the Super Bowl that can't play in the Pro Bowl?
They don't like to play that game anyway, between you and me. Stepping away, Gilbert. So, Colt McCoy. And when you think about this year, ladies and gentlemen, remember how the season began? It was Sam Bradford. He was the reigning Heisman Trophy winner. There was Tim Tebow. He'd won a Heisman at Florida. There was Colt McCoy. There were the three great quarterbacks. Now think about what happened. Sam Bradford injured against BYU, knocked out by Texas down there as we watch this play unfold with Gilbert. And it's intercepted at the 30-yard line. They get down. The clock will continue to run. That championship trophy is headed back to Tuscaloosa. Let me go back about those quarterbacks. And then Tim Tebow suffered that serious injury. I think it was in a concussion. Maybe it was Kentucky where he hit his head. And then here tonight, Colt McCoy in the national championship game. Just an unbelievable turn of events with three marquee quarterbacks.
Yeah, no question about it. And obviously in the championship game, you hate to see Colt go down. Really been impressed with Gilbert here. He just locks in and didn't even see Javier Arenas throws it right into his chest. And again, that's just part of being a young quarterback. And as soon as he threw it, he knew that he had made the mistake. But Arenas has had a brilliant career in his years in Tuscaloosa. And it's fitting for him as much as it is for Ingram for him to come up with a big turnover and get the interception.
It's been a long time between championships as Richardson comes in. There's a penalty flag thrown downfield. And you think about Nick Saban.
Base mask. Number 38 of the defense. Penalty half the distance to the goal line from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
Only his third year, the controversy that was stirred up, speaking of South Florida, when he left the Dolphins. And now Nick Saban, he'll win his second national championship. Remember, he led LSU to a title in New Orleans over Oklahoma. And now here tonight, on the strength of a very well-coached, well-recruited defense, the Crimson Tide will be rolling back to Tuscaloosa with their first national championship since 92. And when you think of these two as Richardson battles toward the end zone, you think about these two coaches, Herbie, they're not going to have to dial up a loan anytime soon. These are two of the highest salaries in the country. There's Mac Brown, 2009 salary. And look at what Nick Saban came up with tonight, a little $400,000 worth of extra sugar. Now that's going good.
That's not too bad.
He's a big individual winner tonight. And there's Mac Brown, tough night. The team certainly did not quit. They deserve very high marks for hanging in here in the second half. McIlroy comes back to Los Angeles. Richardson barges into the end zone, his second of the night. I mean, they got him with emphasis.
That was actually,
that felt good.
That might have been
those rules. That was with emphasis.
Was there contact there? I mean, that wasn't just Gatorade.
No,
that was some plastic.
We're coming at it.
I mean, this is getting a little physical here, boys.
We've had enough of his rules.
Bang!
We rule.
That left ear feel?
We rule right now.
That's taking Gatorade shower to a different level there. He turned right into that baby.
That's one of the all-time best.
Oh, that's man. For
faking the punt early, Coach. Oh, he wouldn't be happy until the game's over.
Look, he's going to eventually smile. He'll get it going. When it's all said and done.
Oh, Tippett hit the upright. No good. That's no way to end a record-breaking career. Slam one off the upright.
I just want to echo what you said about Nick Saban. It is just his third year, what he was able to do this year. Last year, undefeated in the regular season, got close to the championship game, lost to Florida, ended up losing their bowl game. I really think they use those last two games as motivation to get them ready for this year. And in just his third year, this program with Nick Saban at the helm will get stronger and stronger and stronger. And then on the other side, we have to say about Mack Brown, you lose Colt McCoy in the second series of the game, and you fight back to get it to 24-21. A lot of those players in the burnt orange uniforms, when they go into that locker room, they're frustrated, discouraged, but they didn't give up, and that's what you really got to appreciate about that.
Well, a reminder now to stay tuned for your late local news, Nightline and Jimmy Kimmel Live over most of these ABC stations. And, of course, over on ESPN, you want to turn to SportsCenter for all the post-game analysis. I'm sure you'll be hearing from Colt McCoy, hearing from Coach Saban. And how about Greg McIlroy? Did not have, by any means, a spectacular game here tonight. Threw the ball only 11 times. But the last time he lost a football game as a starting quarterback was in the eighth grade. Unbeaten at South Lake outside of Dallas. Unbeaten now with the Crimson Tide. And he has just quarterbacked a national championship game. He's a Rhodes Scholar. And he'll be back next year. And Mark Ingram, he snapped that jinx. A Heisman Trophy winner who came up huge here tonight. There is the list of those who have won the Heisman and the national championship. And it's a short list. A lot more have failed lately.
Since 1950.
That's something
incredible.
For that screen, there's Goodwin picking his way and out of bounds as the final 30 minutes come up. And
we talked about Alabama next year being a team. How about with Gilbert, the way he grew up, the Texas Longhorns, they're probably not going to miss a beat. All of a sudden, the experience he gained tonight will be invaluable in 2010 as he gets ready to take over for Colt McCoy permanently.
Absolutely. Gilbert. Deflected and intercepted. Picked off on the deflection by Alabama's Tyrone King, a senior who's out just bringing the clock down from Birmingham, Alabama. So now he's got to go back and get that championship cap off.
Yeah, he had the national championship hat on, and he's pretty fired up. Playing high school football at South Lake Carroll, one of the perennial powers, not just in the state of Texas, but really respected nationally. You can imagine this is a little bit extra sweet for Greg McIlroy.
Now Nick will allow himself to say, nice job. Still not smiling. That'll do it. Crimson Tide wins the national championship. The Bear would be proud. Let's go to Tom Rinaldi with Coach Saban.
Coach, you knew it wasn't going to be easy when Texas closed to within three late in the fourth quarter. What was your message to your defense?
Well, our message at halftime was we got to play for 60 minutes. You know, championship teams and teams that get to this point are going to be able to come back, and they certainly did, and that speaks well for the character of their team and their coaching staff. And, you know, they did a great job of coming back. I was proud of the way our guys bounced back, though, in the fourth quarter.
The first coach to win two BCS national championships with two different schools. Allow yourself this. What does it mean to you?
Well, really what it means to me is I'm so happy for our entire team. You know, our fans who have been great ever since we've been in Alabama, the players, the great job that they've done in buying in to do what we need to do, our coaching staff and everybody in the organization, our administration, Mal Moore, Dr. Witt, everybody has, you know, made a great team, and that's why this team is good. It's not just because of me. I'm proud of the team, and I'm proud of the way they played today. And I'm really proud of the state of Alabama and our folks that this means a lot to.
You think the Tide would be back this fast?
Well, I never had a timetable for it. We just try to do what we need to do every day from a process standpoint to get better. And I'm really proud of the way our guys competed today.
The process and now the result. Congratulations, Nick. Lisa Salters now.
Thank you, Tom. I'm with Texas quarterback Colt McCoy. Colt, what was it like for you to watch this game, your last game in a Longhorn uniform from the sideline?
I love this game. I have a passion for this game. I've done everything I can to contribute to my team. And we made it this far, and it's unfortunate I didn't get to play. I'd have given everything I had to be out there with my team. But congratulations to Alabama. I love the way our team fought. Garrett Gilbert stepped in and played as good as he could play. You know, he did a tremendous job, and I always give God the glory. I never question why things happen the way they do. God is in control of my life, and I know that nothing else. I'm standing on the rock.
What have doctors told you about the extent of your injury to your shoulder?
You know, I really have no pain in my arm. I just can't feel my arm. It wasn't a painful hit. I've taken that hit over and over my whole life. Playing this game, I know you're going to get hit. I guess I got hit the right way. Like I said, I'm not in pain. My arm's dead. You know, it feels like I slept on my arm, woke up, and it's dead. So, I don't know.
Well, it's been a pleasure watching you these last 4 years. Best of luck to you in the future, Colt.
Thank you. Thank you. Congrats to Alabama. Tremendous football team.
Thank you. Let's head over to Tom Rinaldi. Tom.
Thanks very much, Lisa. Here with Mark Ingram. Mark, I know it was a very, very difficult game for you. I know you're in some pain right now. Heisman Trophy, national championship. How do you describe the journey of this season?
Just the whole entire organization from the top to the bottom. That's all we work for. We set that goal in the beginning of the year, and we work for it, and we deserve it. I don't think anybody in the country worked harder than us, and just played a great game today. And I got to give credit to the entire team because it was a team effort, and I could have did it by myself.
I know your dad was watching you tonight. What message did you send him with how you played?
Man, I love you, man. We did it. We did it. You're number one, baby. I love you.
As a proud son to a proud father. Congratulations, Mark. Brent?
Tom and Lisa, thank you. Thank you very much. And I think that a whole lot of folks, Herbie, have seen just the kind of impressive young men that we deal with around the landscape of college football. The Alabama team coming away with another national championship. And what are your thoughts that you're taking away from this?
Number one, Alabama played nearly perfect game when they played Florida because that was a real goal for them. I really wonder, I think a lot of people wondered, could they recreate that same magic and intensity? And they were able to do it. They also were able to take advantage of the opportunity when McCoy went down. Give Texas all the credit in the world for not going away and quitting and fighting back to get it within a three-point game. But at the end of the day, the champion in college football this year, very, very deserving that it's the Alabama Crimson Tide.
Exactly. Well, they still have the presentation of the Coach's Trophy, presented by Dr. Pepper, when we continue here tonight on ABC.
Amazing grace, how sweet a sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was But now I found I was blind. But now I see.
Fire, natural disasters, and even mold. We take care of them all, anytime, day or night, from cleanup to reconstruction. Tell your insurance provider you prefer First Restoration Services.
I'm here to buy a new Kia, please.
Here's your keys, and here's your cash.
Yes!
It's cash in a Kia at Paramount Kia. Just buy a new Kia, and we'll pay you cash.
I'm paying on my credit card.
Up to $8,000. While they last, new Kia Sorentos for just $244 a month, including Kia's 10-year, 100,000-mile limited warranty. Buy a new Kia, and we'll pay you cash, up to $8,000. It's a fact, Kias cost less in Asheville, only at Paramount Kia.
Make your home more energy efficient. Call Glencoe Foam today.
One of those moments at the end of a championship game, Mark Ingram and Colt McCoy, who embraced at the Heisman Trophy ceremony, do it here again. After Ingram's Crimson Tide conquers the Longhorns, time to present the hardware. Let's go down below to John Saunders. John.
Brent, thanks a lot. And we should first congratulate on another great season head coach Mack Brown and the Texas Longhorns. But it is time now to hand out the championship trophy presented by Dr. Pepper to the national champions. And to do that is ACC Commissioner and BCS Commissioner John Swoffer.
John, thank you very much. On behalf of the institutions of the 11 conferences that participate in the Bowl Championship Series, let me first of all congratulate both of these teams on tremendous seasons and a great effort tonight. And now, on behalf of the American Football Coaches Association, it is my distinct pleasure to present the Coaches Trophy, symbolic of this year's national champions, to Coach Nick Saban and the University of Alabama.
Coach, it hasn't been that long since you've been hoisting that trophy, back to 2003, but that's another story with another school. It's been a long time for Alabama, 1992, their last national championship. So talk about what it means for the Alabama faithful.
Well, first of all, this is something that is special for the state of Alabama. It's special for the University of Alabama. It's special for our fans and our great supporters, but we have a great team at the University of Alabama, starting with our president, Dr. Robert Witt, Mal Moore, our athletic director, our entire coaching staff and administrative staff, and the great players who bought in and sold out and did a lot of blood, sweat, and tears to get to where we are right now. So a lot of people created this for us, and I can only thank them for the great effort that they made. It means a tremendous amount to all of us in the state of Alabama and at the University of Alabama to win the BCS National Championship.
You and I talked about four nights ago, and you said as far as bringing a group of young men together with one single mind, this is as good a group as you have ever seen.
Well, they certainly are. They all bought into the things that we needed to do, which was work hard to dominate the competition, be a team, play together as a team, and also have discipline to execute in everything that they did. And the message tonight was, do what we do and be who we are. And I thought we did a good job of that after the first quarter.
Well, congratulations. We want to bring in the offensive MVP, who's used to bringing in a little hardware. Mark, come on over here for a little while. Congratulations. Mark Ingram, offensive MVP. First of all, the Heisman Trophy, and got to tell you, you're only the second Heisman Trophy winner who's also won the BCS Championship, so congratulations.
Thank you.
Which is sweeter?
Man, this championship, we had our eyes set on it since the beginning of the year, and just to do it with the whole team is truly a team effort, and I'm just so proud of everybody because we worked hard for it.
You had one of the greatest speeches in Heisman Trophy history. You brought tears to the eyes of so many people, and I know you did that again on the field today. What do you have to say to these fans?
I'm just so blessed, and I'm so happy to do this for the entire Alabama family. We've been waiting a long time, and we bet.
Congratulations. Marcel Darius, get over here. Defensive player of the game, ladies and gentlemen. And a big smile on his face as well. Early on in this game, when the offense was having problems going, the defense took control of the game and clearly set the tone for how this game would be played.
Yeah, we did work hard. We always told the offense we had their back. It don't matter what problems we was in. <It's> a, I don't know how much to say on that. Just, I can't remember.
Marcel, congratulations. By the way, you look good going towards the end zone as well. Congratulations to the Alabama Crimson Tide. Right now, let's send it back to Brent Musburger.
John, thank you very much. And a reminder that you can be the first to own a piece of history, the Alabama-Texas BCS National Championship victory. Download the full-length game. Go to iTunes.com/ESPN and click on the BCS logo, iTunes.com/ESPN. I thought about what Mark Ingram said after the Heisman Trophy ceremony. He said, that trophy's heavier than you might think. This one a lot lighter, but it means a lot more because it's a team trophy. Mark Ingram. And the Alabama Crimson Tide rolls tonight in Pasadena.
Get to his house. He has 13 monkeys.
You know, there's something I've been wanting to tell you. I love you.
And I...
So cute. Another Miller Lite?
I'd love one. Thank you.
Do you love the taste of your beer this much? Well, you could. Try the great Pilsner taste of a...